Thank you. It is time. Give the stream a thumbs up. We're at 67 likes. Let me turn down my music a little bit. All right. Bro, what's up, everybody? What's up? It is time for Nintendo to put up shut up. It's time. What's up, everybody? Am I ready? I'm nervous. What's up, Zach, with the $3 super chat, Nintendo Direct hype. It's time because all the other presentations were trash. Hey, let me, my air conditioning, turn it down a little bit so warm. We're all good. All right, what's up? If you're coming into the chat, we're at 81 likes. Let's get it over 100 likes. Let's do the countdown. The countdown is official, 1 minute, 47 seconds. I got the 47 minutes, 1 hour, 47 minutes. It's time. No more playing games. It's time. Oh, we should get a new Smash Brothers character. Smash is cool and all, but I want to be blown away, Nintendo. Let's go, man. Hey, you're eating some waffle and eggs, scrambled eggs. I don't know. I might play some Ratchet and Clank live while we're waiting. Kill the time. We got a lot of time. Yeah. You just give me a thumbs up though, man. I'm being a voice chat in a second, Jonas. I don't care right now, Nintendo have a better showcase than Xbox. Watch. Big Dizzle. Nintendo's gonna be better than Xbox. That was a low bar, bro. I wasn't impressed by Xboxes. Shout out to Big Dizzle for the $5 super chat. Bro, Nintendo's gonna win. Nintendo's going to win. Meet the Slash Waffle, now hopping the voice chat. But I'm gonna hop out the voice chat to play Ratchet and Clank. So many cutscenes in the game, bro. Hold on. A long recording on Switch. I want achievements on the Switch. I want more features for my Switch. All right, I got my eggs to the side. Let's go. Should be lit. Yo, Jonas. Can you hear me?
What's up, Obi?
I'm good, man. How you doing?
I'm so nervous, yeah, dude. Yeah, my stomach is feeling weird.
Hey, what's up?
I'm nervous too, bro. Nintendo has to perform. Real quick, we're at 91 likes. Nine more people give the stream a thumbs up. We'll pass 100 likes. Go ahead, Jonas.
I can't remember the last time my stomach feel weird like this for a Nintendo Direct.
It's because it's been a... Last year, they skipped the Nintendo Direct at E3, right? And the last Nintendo...
Yeah, there was no E3 last year.
Yeah.
They did something, but I don't think it was in June.
Yeah. But the last Direct they had, it was not good. It wasn't good at all. And so this one...
Are you talking about the Direct in February?
Whichever one that last one was. No, not the one in February. Maybe that was the one in February or the one before that.
Do you talk about the one when they announced Splatoon 3 and
No, not that one. Not that one, because Splatoon 3 was enough. Splatoon 3 saved it. There was another one before that. Hey, what's up, Danny? What's up, Evo Hodis? What's up, Late Show?
What's going on, y'all?
Chilling, man.
Way to work, man, but I'm gonna be with y'all in spirit.
I know, Mario. Let's go, Mario. I'm nervous,
let's
Mario.
Go, bro. And Breath of the Wild 2, and they can just end the video. Breath of the Wild 2 and Mario Kart 9, they can just end the whole presentation right there.
Metro Prime 4 or bust. Now, don't get me wrong, Mario Kart 9 would be lit. Yes. But I want a Metroid Prime 4 update, man. We need an update for Prime 4.
It's been 4 years since they announced it first at E3.
Yeah, it's been too long, bro.
Yeah, it's been a while. It's been a while.
Also, we might get something about Metroid this
E3.
Yeah.
I still remember your reaction when you said, "My iPad is discombobulated."
Discombobulated, yeah. That was when they showed what? Metroid?
The teaser with the 4, and they said now in development.
Y'all don't understand. But here's my thing. Like, I'm being honest. Like, after playing, I got my Metroid fix from playing Returnal on my PS5, but I still want to see Metro Prime 4. I still want to see it.
I think
Nintendo is definitely going to show something big in this event, bro.
They got a whole bunch of stuff planned. They have to.
Bro.
All these rumors going around, but all of this stuff coming out, some of it's got to be real.
Bro, for Nintendo, it's a wide open layup for E3. I mean, every conference, in my opinion, was trash.
All you got to do is be Microsoft. Microsoft only had 2 fire games.
Only Halo and Forza, man. That was it.
Yep. Yeah, that was pretty good. Xbox was pretty good.
Nah, I wasn't impressed.
Isn't Nintendo, after, like, when Nintendo's done its Bandai Namco?
What about Bandai? Yeah. Now, here's the thing.
Yeah,
we're going to do the Nintendo
Bandai Namco.
Yeah, I'm staying on for Bandai Namco, too.
Yes.
Yeah, I'm going to be off for Nintendo Direct.
Was Bandai only at 5:25 p.m.?
What?
Bandai is at 5 p.m., I think.
For you, it's a different time zone for me.
No, I'm the same time
zone. Oh, yeah, it is. Bro, it's going to be that late? Oh, man, I'm going to be on for a minute.
Wait, day 4, E3.
No, you're right, because the Treehouse is going to do 3 hours of gameplay and then...
Wait, I'm gonna check to be sure.
Yeah, no, that sounds right.
Namco should have some fire, bro.
That sounds right, Jonas.
I'm just hoping from Namco Pac-Man. Come on, just give us a new Pac-Man game.
A new Pac-Man, a new Tekken, and a new Dragon Ball, and I'll be good with all that.
Obi, Bandai Namco is at 5:25 p.m.
Yeah.
Eastern Standard Time.
Man, that late? Jeez Louise.
Yeah, that late.
That's real late. Why are they going so late?
At 12, we're going to get the Direct for 40 minutes. At 12:40, we're going to get 3 hours of Nintendo Treehouse.
Yeah.
So it's led us to 3:40 p.m. Eastern. So they're going to take a break, I think, and Namco at 5:25.
Namco better give us some power.
We'll see, man. Bandai Namco has to break.
They are starting late then because Nintendo has like a long event thing going on. So
yeah. So it's gonna be late. Mario
Kart 9, bro.
It depends how this Nintendo Direct goes. I might just be mad and be like, "Man, forget this."
Can I predict something?
Go ahead.
I think that, just remember 2 weeks ago there was a leak about the Nintendo Switch Pro gonna be announced the day after.
Yeah.
So the I think I know they said that the Direct is gonna be exclusively focused on softwares. But you know Nintendo is like to surprise us.
Yeah.
Yes, so even they're gonna announce the first thing they're gonna show is the Switch Pro, or the last thing, the one more thing is gonna be we announce officially the Switch Pro, and all the gameplay you have seen today on the Direct was recorded on the Switch Pro.
Hey, if they launch the Switch Pro, I'm telling y'all right now on stream.
Yeah.
I'm taking lunch. I'm going to GameStop and pre-ordering the Switch Pro.
Yeah, that's right. The Switch Pro.
I'm telling you. The stream is. I'm going straight to GameStop. Yeah, I'll be back.
Stream's shutting down if that Switch Pro's announced.
Oh yeah, I'm gonna say this though. If we do get the Switch Pro and the pre-orders go right after the Direct,
I'm gone. Be
prepared, because once this thing sells out, who knows? Because you know what's happening with the PS5 and the Series X. Who knows when the next Switch Pro shipment might be?
Exactly. I'm leaving work and I'm going to go pre-order my stuff, bro. It's not a game.
Yeah.
It's not a game, bro.
Brandon with the $2 chat says, "Obi, don't get copyright strike, Nintendo ninjas." Yeah, Nintendo.
It's an evidence that it's written in the sky that the Switch Pro is real. They're gonna show it, we don't know.
Yeah,
but it's real.
Right.
Yeah,
it's real. It's happening.
Yeah, it is happening. The Nintendo already said that they were working on more powerful hardware.
Obi already did a video.
Even the president of Nintendo was like, "We need new hardware." So.
Yeah, it's just, when are they gonna show it? That's it. Just when are they gonna show it, man?
You gotta show it now. It's been 5 years. You can't keep launching.
That's what I'm saying. I think
it's four years.
It's been four years. But here's the thing. I'm gonna read the description of the Direct, and I'm gonna share why it could still happen. It said, "Tune in for a Nintendo Direct with roughly 40 minutes of info focused exclusively on Nintendo Switch software, mostly releasing in 2021, followed by around 3 hours of gameplay for a handful of Nintendo Switch games and Nintendo Switch Treehouse Live." Now, first, the mostly releasing 2021, meaning most of the games were 2021, but they still have some announcements beyond 2021. I'm thinking Metroid Prime 4. But they did say focus exclusively on software. And so they're setting expectations for just software, meaning they could step outside of it and still do something, but they try to let you know it's going to be a software-focused Direct. So I don't know what, because they have before said that the Direct is not going to show any games beyond like 2019, and they did do that. They broke that rule. So they haven't always stuck to what it said in the description.
They always have broken rules.
Fingers crossed.
Like the one for February, they said, go ahead, Jonas, sorry.
Do you really think that they're going to say, "Tune in for Nintendo Direct with roughly 40 minutes into focused into Nintendo Switch software and new hardware"?
Yeah. You're right. There's no way they would put it in the description.
Do you really think they're going to spoil next console?
If they literally in the title and the description they say "and new hardware," that'll ruin the surprise.
That's it.
There's no way they would say "and new hardware." The internet would go crazy.
So you understand
crazy.
That they can announce it.
Yeah, so they could say that even if they wanted to, they couldn't do that.
Yeah.
So
it's like I say you, "Hey, tune in, go see Star Wars The Force Awakens on December 15th. Oh, by the way, Han Solo dies."
Yeah, I know, right? Yeah, you're right, Jonas.
Right. There
ain't no way in the world. They ain't gonna just flat out spoil it. Hey, let's go, man. But hey, I'm nervous, Jonas. I'm right there with you, bro.
Oh my God.
Bro, Jonas, if we're in the same room right now, we'll be standing next to each other holding hands, bro. I'm so nervous.
Y'all holding hands, I'm gonna be right behind y'all. I'm nervous too, bro.
Oh man, I'm just hoping that here's the thing that I notice always about Nintendo. With E3, sure, they had some bad E3s, but let me tell you, they always find a way to surprise people. And I hope they do it this year.
Me too. I hope they do today too, man.
Because this year, for E3, it was not good. Nah. It really wasn't.
Nah. It's been the worst.
It would be nice if they announced the Switch Pro and at least give everybody 24 hours before they make the pre-orders
go live. Here's my thing. That
would be nice.
No, Lake Show, that's what Sony tried to do. The retailers ain't gonna listen because they try to get it.
And they're gonna do it again.
They're trying to. Ain't no way in the world Walmart gonna see GameStop starting early, and we're not gonna do it. They're trying to up one each other to get their money, and so they can say it. But go ahead.
It's a good thing I know a GameStop manager. I'll just call him and say, "Hey, look, just hold a pre-order for me. I'll be coming to get it."
I'm going, bro. I'm making a beeline. I'll set up a separate live stream on my phone while I'm live streaming, going to get my Switch Pro
and drive 100 miles an hour.
It's serious, bro. It's a must. But I always know dudes that usually get a couple consoles. Johnny, shout out to Johnny. If Johnny get a couple extra, you know what I'm saying, have backup plans. But, man, it's going to be crazy.
I got to get my pre-order.
Oh, yeah, it's going to be crazy.
Yeah, man. And OB line. Switch Pro 350. Now, the rumor was, I did hear 350 and I did hear 400. I'm actually, what's up, Johnny? I see you laughing. I'm hoping that it's 400. The more expensive, the more hopeful I am, because that means.
Yeah, the more expensive, the better hardware. That's what I'm saying.
I don't care if it's 600. I'm still going to buy it.
No, but here's my thing. The more expensive it is, the more that I know, okay, Nintendo's like putting. It's going to be a powerful system. If it's like the same price as the Switch, I'm a little nervous. If it's $299 for a portable
PS5.
Nah, I don't think Nintendo going to go that high in price. RTX, who's RTX Soldier? I know it's a spot. Yo, what's up? Who's that, Johnny?
Yeah.
My dude changed his name. He changed his name to RTX Soldier.
RTX Soldier.
What's up, Johnny? You got the 3090? I thought I saw you post that, bro. You lit, man. You lit. Hey, man. Hey, Jordan the Kitsune, thanks for subscribing to the channel. But, man, I'm just hoping Nintendo does not disappoint. Yeah. I know you be getting them systems, bro. You be my backup, bro. Get an extra one, bro.
I mean, in the early weeks like last time on the PS5.
Yeah. Hey,
if
you get an extra system, you already know, bro. I have thirds in the YouTube chat. What do you think we'll get for Smash? I have to say, man. Smash hasn't really been on my radar, but if I had to choose somebody, probably Crash. Crash Bandicoot makes sense, man. That's the last iconic gaming character for me that I think is missing from Smash. We got Pac-Man, Sonic. I think Crash, bro, back in the day when Sega, Genesis, and Sony came in, Crash Bandicoot was the PlayStation mascot. Go ahead, Jonas.
Waluigi,
or...
It needs to happen. There's two more. There's two last characters.
Yeah, you're right.
There's going to be one that we don't know what it is, but the last one.
What's up, Ant?
The last one. They need to put Waluigi in the game.
Yeah, they need to, but it's Nintendo. Hey, real quick, we're at 125 likes. I need 25 people. Give the stream a thumbs up. Let's crush 150 likes right now live on stream. Let's do it. Bro, what's up, broken? Your custom controller broken ain't got nothing on this all black boy, midnight black. Mm-hmm. Your custom is just black. This is midnight, bro. It's blacker than black, black, black. Hey, Bucks, what's up, bro? What up, Bucks? Hey, what would put a smile on your face today from Nintendo, Bucks?
Man, I don't even know, man. I need to see something. I need to see, I need to see something crazy.
Yeah.
I need to see. I want to see a. Uh-huh. I would love. I don't think it's gonna ever happen. Uh-huh. I'd love to see a. Star Fox game,
bro. Bro, I haven't even thought about that. Yes.
Yeah.
Bro, I'd Nintendo. Love to
see a Star Fox game.
That's why Nintendo like so. Gets me so disappointed. I don't understand.
They have these fire. They have these fire IPs and they don't use them.
They just sit them, bro.
It don't make sense.
Imagine
that'd
they
be like, show. The that'd be like for the Wii U.
The one for the Wii U is trash. But what were you saying?
We ain't count the Wii U, bro. Yeah. Honestly, the last one in my opinion, was the 64.
Yeah, that's the one. That was the last. That was the last. That was the best one. The one on the GameCube was all right. Star Fox Assault was all right. Yeah, yeah, yeah. But they still haven't reached that Nintendo 64 Star Fox level, man.
Here's the thing, Like them not using their IPs.
Yeah.
Is like honestly, it's like imagine if Insomniac didn't put out any more Spider-Mans.
Yeah, I know, man. It's like
that's kind of how I feel sometimes.
Yeah, and it's like the fans want it. Nintendo's like, nope.
It's not just one game either. There's F-Zero. What happened
to F-Zero? They got a couple, man.
What happened to Diddy Kong Racing?
What's up, guys?
You know what I mean? Like, they talk about they don't want to put out another Mario Kart. What about Diddy Kong Racing?
That's what I'm saying. Because even though Rare made Diddy Kong Racing, but it's Nintendo's IP, bro. Diddy Kong is Nintendo. And so they could make a Diddy Kong Racing with just like different characters.
I guarantee they could call Rare and make a deal, and they would let them do it.
Yeah, man, they don't even need to call Rare. Diddy Kong is theirs. They just can't use some of the Banjo and Kazooie characters.
But I'm sure they can make a deal with that though.
Yeah,
Banjo for Smash. I'm sure they can make a deal.
They probably make a deal behind the scenes. Yes,
I'm pretty sure they have a good relationship. Like
facts, they can make a deal. Facts. It'll be cross promotion for Xbox.
I don't know. I know they want to like spread things out or whatever. Yeah. But it's been how long now? When did the Switch come out? Like. It came out
March 2017.
Yeah.
I think it's about time we need to start seeing some IPs.
Facts. Some new ones, man. Now I think if they go this direct without any Splatoon 3 or Breath of the Wild 2, that's a big miss because I think those are just easy giving. Easy updates.
But here's my opinion on that. They don't need to spend too much time on them because they already kind of showed us.
No.
They don't need to spend too much.
Yeah.
I'm not saying don't spend any.
Yeah.
I'm just saying don't spend the whole direct on those because we also want to see other IPs.
Yeah, fact.
I'm thinking it's going to be one of those, like, hit, like, you know, when it's like bang, 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 trailer. And that's they're going to go into detail with it after, because there's a 3-hour treehouse.
Yeah.
So I feel like the details will be fine after. With
that. Yeah. The only game I want them to go into detail is Metro Prime 4. I don't care if they spend 10 minutes on Prime 4.
If they show it, it's not going to go into detail.
Everything else, I just want 1 minute, 2 minute, no more than 2 minutes on the game. Bam, go to the next game. Bam. Hey, Brandon with the $5 super chat. Bro, Nintendo just said they will prosecute streamers. Are you still going to stream? Don't get taken down, man. Now, Nintendo wants you to live stream this stuff. They're good.
Because for USA and Europe, it's okay. But in Japan, Nintendo of Japan tweeted this morning about they don't want to streamers to co-stream the direct, but it's only for Japan.
That's lame.
They tweeted that they don't want. I don't know, but they said they don't want streamers to like stream that event. But why? Nintendo of America or Nintendo of Europe didn't say anything, so I think they
Bro, that would have been
Japan's a lot more strict.
That would have been a riot, bro. What's up, Supreme?
I've been talking with some French YouTubers, and they talked directly to Nintendo of France, and they said that it's okay to stream it in France and US.
Yeah. That's Anthony, in the YouTube show, they said that's only. But that's even lame, even for Japan. Why?
I know.
Yeah,
that's what I'm saying.
I feel like when Nintendo Japan announced that on their Twitter, I was like, but for what? You know, like, it doesn't make no sense unless if they have something big to announce.
Yeah.
But I don't think that's the reason for them to do that.
Yeah. And here's the thing. Sometimes those Japan directs they show different games than the US ones.
Yeah, they do.
So you gotta go back sometimes and watch them. They're different.
Yeah,
what's up, Broken? What's up, bro?
I think what's different though is it's E3 though. Don't they? E3 stays the same, right?
I don't remember. Nintendo don't be sticking by any rules, bro. Hey, bro, with 140 likes, 10 people give the stream a thumbs up. Let's crush. 150 likes. Let's go, bro.
You guys want to see?
We're here.
You guys want to see where I'm at?
What's up, Bucks? Where you at, bro?
Look at this, bro. Look at this weather, man. Look at this. All week.
Oh man, that's what it was here. I had to get all up, leaving work.
100, bro. I thought it was hot in Florida, bro. That's crazy.
California, dude, it's like everywhere hot, right now, man.
Thursday's crazy. Gonna be 107.
Oh yeah,
man.
Bro.
Man,
and we dry, and see that we have 2% humidity. We dry here, so it's dry.
Oh, that makes it worse, bro.
It's like you're cooking in the oven.
I know, bro. That's like suffocating. At least there's some humidity in Florida.
Cooking, man.
Yeah. Are you like in the California area or?
Yeah, I live in California.
Oh, let's go, man. Hey, what about Virtual Console? Will they announce Nintendo 64?
Yes, we need Virtual Console. We really need Virtual Console.
I mean, not Virtual Console, but like Nintendo 64, like how they get the free NES and Super Nintendo.
Yeah, I wouldn't mind that either.
Yeah. That'd be cool.
That would be cool, but I just want new stuff. I really want a lot of new games.
Facts. I want new games and surprises with the Switch Pro, bro. My expectations still for a Switch Pro.
There you go. Exactly.
Obviously, the Direct is not going to be 40 minutes. They might be like a few extra minutes because they always say, it's going to be 40 minutes, but it ends up being like 42-something minutes.
But it says roughly 40, so it's not going to be exactly 40 minutes.
That's true.
Yeah, roughly 40 minutes.
Switch Pro is trending again.
Yeah. That was when I was waiting for Xbox to deliver. I'm done waiting, AJ. I was waiting, bro. I was like, they coming. All these studios is happening. Man, dud. Twilight Princess for the Switch. Been there, done that a couple times on different systems for the GameCube.
You know what?
Go ahead, Bucks.
I will say though if they made like, I wouldn't say as a single game, right, but if they did like a collection with like Ocarina of Time, Majora's Mask, and Twilight Princess, like kind of like how they did the Mario 3D All-Stars,
yeah,
that would sell though. That would sell.
Oh yeah.
I could see them doing something like that. But if they're gonna do it,
yeah,
every single one of those better be HD.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. I think because it's Zelda 35th anniversary, I think they're gonna do something for it. But I'm not
the same as Mario.
I can't get hyped over that, man. I played those games so many times.
The messed up part is too that Zelda is always like the redhead stepchild for some reason.
Sometimes
they be treating Mario way better. Yeah, like Mario gets all those like extra like packs and all that stuff. I don't know, man.
I think Zelda's gonna be different though. Yeah. I think with Breath of the Wild 2 and stuff, it's gonna get. But this year, for the 35th, is going to get a lot of good stuff for Zelda, I feel like. Especially because their last Zelda game just won them Game of the Year.
Yeah. So, that was the last time they had the Game of the Year.
That's what I'm saying. They're focused on them big Zelda games. Fox.
Facts, Broken. That was a good selection. I'm not too hyped for Bayonetta 3, but I still want to see it.
I want to see it, yeah. They revealed that at, the first Game Awards after the Switch came out,
and then they
right?
just stopped, man. They just stopped.
Oh, and if anybody's thinking about...
Go ahead, Bucks.
If anybody's thinking that you're gonna hear anything about a Switch Pro, no, you know nothing about it.
We might. Fingers crossed. Nah. But Jonas made a good point. Nah. Like even though they said in the description, stay tuned for info focused or exclusively on Nintendo Switch hardware. They couldn't say new Nintendo Switch hardware. Exactly. Like they can't say that in the description. The internet would go crazy,
That is true. But I'm not getting my hopes up.
I'm getting my hopes up. Nintendo need to do something.
They're gonna do it like if you look at somebody made a good point the other day. Oh, I was watching. You know who Nintendo Prime is?
Yeah.
Okay, so I was watching his thing the other day. And he made a good point actually. He was talking about how the Switch Lite. Remember how they dropped the Switch Lite? It was just like a trailer.
Yeah.
If the Switch Pro is gonna come out where everyone says, like Bloomberg and all these articles, they say it's gonna come out like
September to October.
September to October. That was the same time frame I think as the Switch Lite, and when they announced the Switch Lite was in July. So yeah,
the difference though is like
Nintendo Prime is thinking they might do like a July, like a little drop, like a little.
But I have to say though, but Nintendo has no rhyme or reason with this stuff, man. Like sometimes they do it in July, but they
don't do patterns. I get what you're saying.
Yeah,
sometimes
yeah.
they do and sometimes they don't.
Yeah. I feel like the Switch Pro would have to be something they showed E3 because, like we've all been saying, they do something new every 5 years, right? This is like their next console in a way, even though it's still the Switch.
It's come close. Yeah,
didn't
yeah.
one of them though come out though and say like they made it a point that they weren't gonna show any hardware? Or no, did they not?
That what?
So they the only point they've made is their tweet
yeah.
I thought somebody said something in an interview or something.
No, on their even right now the actual stream, what we're waiting to watch. It says tune in for Nintendo Direct, roughly 40 minutes of info focused exclusively on Nintendo Switch software. So that's what they said. But because just imagine they said focus exclusive on Nintendo Switch software and new Nintendo Switch hardware. They can't say that. They can't say that they're gonna.
Nintendo has lied before. Remember when the new 3DS came out before that? They said,
"Yeah,
oh, we're not coming out with any more 3DSs." And then right after that, they came
with no new hardware.
Anything because if they say something, it's gonna surprise people.
Well, and they don't want people to stop. Surprise.
Yeah.
Well, think about how bad of a business it. Yeah, think about how bad a business move it is to tell people, imagine telling people, don't buy our current Switch, just wait on the new one. Like, they're not going to tell you that. They want you to keep buying the current
And they just
one.
Had a restock Switch today, actually, at GameStop.
There's a lot of Switches. You can still get Switches on Amazon, too, and, like, all kinds
of
places.
But we know it's
so,
not
like,
fake because it the...
No, it's not fake. No one's saying it's fake. No, we know it's real. Because the same people at Bloomberg that leaked the light... Uh-huh. Are the same people they're talking to now about the Pro. So we know it's real.
Yeah.
I'm not saying that. It's definitely
just...
real. It's
it's real.
I knew it was
real. It's just know where it's at, what it is.
When they're going to do it.
Yeah.
Even though, you know, it hasn't been confirmed, but even the president of Nintendo, Phil Collins, said, hey, we need some new hardware here because they know that their old big Switch is, you know, it's one and down. It can't run third-party games.
Well, and I think they have to because I think NVIDIA is getting ready to cancel that chipset.
But here's my thing I'm a little worried about because even like some of these cross-gen games that are still supporting the PS4, they're starting to look a little dated now, man. And so I think Nintendo will still be a generation behind even with this new hardware.
That's fine, though.
Because
if they had but think about what they could do with... Because I don't buy... Personally, I don't know about you guys. Uh-huh. I don't buy my Nintendo console for third-party games. So, for me, it's first-party games. So I feel like if they have the power of the PS4, they could do some crazy things with Nintendo games.
They
could.
Some
real crazy... It could be amazing.
They could.
I was watching a Breath of the Wild 2 breakdown, like the trailer breakdown to them, and there was some stuff I didn't even realize. Like the Sheikah Slate is completely removed, all the Sheikah towers and stuff, and the shrines are gone from the game.
I didn't even know that.
Well, because people complained about that. People didn't
I think it's looking like it's going to be like original dungeons and maybe
people
like
people wanted dungeons
and stuff.
But you know, I like those mini dungeons. They were pretty cool, man.
I liked the Sheikah.
Yeah, but
spawn.
There was a lot of people that you know how Nintendo listens, and there was a lot of people that didn't like the little Sheikah Slate towers.
Nintendo
because
fans get wild, though.
Everyone likes those original dungeons.
Yeah.
It's not the same,
but
I mean.
But I don't know. I feel like would they remove all that though? Because that would be wouldn't it be Breath of the Wild 2 then. I feel like.
Well,
like,
no, but like at the end of the game, it talks of like when you beat Ganon, like it says like the Divine Beast. Like power down and all the Sheikah technology shuts down after Ganon dies. That's part of the story.
Yeah, I wonder what
order alert, please. I didn't finish a game yet.
Oh well,
you haven't beaten Jonas. Breath of the Wild yet, Jonas.
Bro, that's not really.
I'm close, but I didn't beat Ganon yet.
You can't go after me.
It's been four years.
Yeah, Ganon's been out since the Switch release. Yeah.
It'd be different if he spoiled something that's new, but come on, man.
I will say this, though. If you're excited for Breath of the Wild 2, man, they're going to be talking heavy spoilers for Breath of the Wild 1 in this game.
Oh, you know what's cool, too? I just realized this morning, the most thing I'm excited for is they have been, like, they've been so tight-lipped on everything.
Uh-huh.
There hasn't been no leaks, like... Really, we don't know what new games are coming. That's what's exciting.
Yeah.
And all the stuff says it releasing in 2021.
Yeah.
That's fire.
Yeah.
Hey, Nintendo could really have the best E3.
That's what I'm saying. Because they're going to be focusing on games coming soon.
They're going to tell Microsoft to hold their beer.
We'll see, man. We'll have to see. We'll see, bro. But like I said, man, it's an easy layup because I haven't been blown away by anything so far at E3, man. So we'll see.
Hey, you think Nintendo could have a better show than PlayStation? Possibly.
Well, PlayStation shows at the end of the month for July.
Sony hasn't had anything, so we'll
see. I'm just saying, could Nintendo just blow us out of the water? Could it get you hyped?
I think
they could. I mean, it depends on what they show, bro.
As a Sony fan, if Nintendo shows the hardware and Breath of the Wild's Splatoon, for me personally, that's all I need. Because Sony, I've got the hardware. I'm excited for God of War. But Nintendo stuff also, I feel like there's a special place in Nintendo games in my heart, man. So hey, good Nintendo games, that's all I want from E3.
Real quick, hey, shout out to Dre Day Reviews with the $5 super chat. I'm going to say this, Breath of the Wild 2 needs some type of instrument in the game, an ocarina, flute, harp, something, and we need temples. That's what we're just talking about. Instead of the mini dungeons, real dungeons. I'm here for either one. I like the mini dungeons, but... Zelda games are known for like those big dungeons, and so I feel you. I appreciate the $5, Dre.
Another thing about Breath of the Wild 2 is it's been the director of Breath of the Wild is the same as Breath of the Wild 2, but he also directed Twilight Princess, and a lot of the stuff in the trailer resembles stuff from Twilight Princess.
Yeah, because Twilight Princess was a little bit more dark.
Looks like they're going the dark route.
There's
these rocks in the game or whatever in the trailer, and like it looks like the trailer that shows them going into a shrine with all these rocks and the rocks in the Breath of the Wild River. So it says those rocks contain the souls of the dead. It looks like they're going into a dead man's chamber or whatever, and then they resurrect an evil being or whatever in the trailer. So
we'll see. Nintendo, don't disappoint.
We are 100% Breath of the Wild 2 today. That's not up for debate.
Nothing's a guarantee with Nintendo, bro.
It is, man. If it isn't, they can't do anything else.
They could be like, we're not ready to show the game yet.
For anyone who didn't, what's
gonna happen is just direct the producer of Zelda. He's just gonna be like, hey guys, I know you guys were expecting some Breath of the Wild 2 news today, but we have nothing.
Hey, you never know, man. But what were you saying, Broken?
Oh, you got a $10 donation.
I posted the ending for Breath of the Wild in your chat. If anybody wants to know the ending,
all right, I'll check it out. Hey, Mac, bro, you a fool, bro. You a fool, Broken. Mac Havoc, that's the homie, with a $10 super chat. I'm calling it Breath of the Wild 2, Holiday 2021, end of stream. That would be dope if it comes out end of 2021. That would be dope.
That would be a holiday game, because I don't think Nintendo even has a holiday game this year.
They haven't announced it. Well, yeah, Pokemon. Those Pokemon remakes, but Pokemon is.
Yeah, but they haven't had this E3 yet either. There's gonna be a lot of holidays. There's gonna be some games.
They usually have something outside of Pokemon.
I mean, they're saying it right here, mostly releasing in 2021. So
we got games coming.
So, AJ.
AJ, what's up? And here's the thing with Nintendo, they tend to like the first half of the year. Quiet, and then E3 they announced the plans for holiday. Nintendo banks a lot on holiday sales, man. So we'll see. We'll see, man. 2020.
I think we're also gonna see some 2022 titles, because I mean Nintendo has said a lot of times like, hey, we're focusing this year, but yeah, they still show like games for next year.
Yeah, they will. Because Derek, thanks for subscribing, because they said it. They said mostly 2021, meaning that they are gonna have games beyond 2021. What's up, everybody? Yeah. We're at 157 likes. Let's try to get the stream to 200 likes. I need everybody. If you haven't, give the stream a thumbs up yet. Give the stream a thumbs up. Let's get it over 200 likes. We have 1 hour, 10 minutes left until the direct. We're just chilling, talking, waiting, watching, being nervous for Nintendo. Here we go, bro. Dun, 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 dun. Man, oh man! Nintendo.
Wait, I thought the direct was at 11.
I still got my PS5 on.
12
Eastern. 12 Eastern, bro. Come on, AJ, get with it, AJ.
Bro, I'm looking at the schedule right now.
I still got my
PS5
on
right now.
Are you in central? Are you in central time? Because that's possibly the reason why. Then it says 11.
Yeah, it's 11 my time. I'm central.
No, no, no. Hey, it starts in 10 minutes, bro.
No, it doesn't.
No,
bro.
It doesn't.
Yeah, I'm looking at the schedule.
I'm on the
bro.
You want me to post the official schedule that they
Bucks, I'm on the official live stream. And the live stream.
They changed the schedule then, because I have the official E3 schedule. They must have changed it.
The official live stream, it says 68 minutes.
Okay, so that means they changed their E3 schedule, because I have the official E3 schedule. And
but,
it says,
right, what Pot of Luck just posted, it says 12 p.m. Eastern Standard Time.
Yeah, yeah, no, but the official
E3 schedule.
Look, your
E3 schedule may be for Central Time or something.
It says E3 posted that. E3 posted that.
Yes.
But Nintendo didn't. E3
11 a.m. Eastern. Yeah, that's wrong.
Because
yeah,
when Nintendo revealed the direct, when Nintendo revealed the direct, they're not 12.
Yeah, that's wrong.
Take 2 changed theirs.
Yeah, it's 12. Yo, Spike, what's up, bro? What up,
that's
bro?
What to say. There's no way. And Nintendo starts at 12, not 11.
No, no. I have the official countdown on the Nintendo YouTube page right here, bro.
We got 6, 8
yeah, minutes. Yeah, no, but I'm saying they changed it. They must have changed it.
I think it's just an error on. I think that's just an error on E3's side.
Yeah, that's an error on E3's part. Because if the schedule changed, then Nintendo
Take-Two's changed. That's why I said that. Because I remember Take-Two they ended up not
trash.
Doing it at 1:15. They ended up doing it at like 2:15 or something.
They should have just canceled that.
Should they? I didn't even watch it.
I heard it was just like a Zoom meeting. They didn't even announce any games.
Oh, I did see it. It was just like somebody said it was like a Zoom meeting. And one of the people in the Zoom was like, just like, yeah. Like some of the stuff wasn't even about games. It was like how their efforts are to make like the gaming industry more open stuff to everyone.
Yeah, they need to. They need to get rid of that. They need to do that. That's just a waste.
What do you guys think Breath of the Wild 2 is gonna be called? If you guys had to make a prediction.
Breath of Fresh Air. The Dawn of Doom. Something crazy. I don't know. I feel
like it'll just be like Breath of the Wild, but like change the word or something.
I don't know. Hey, Michael Parker with the $5. Salute, salute, salute. Let's go.
Which is like Breath of the Dead or something.
Mike, what up, bro? What's up, Mike?
It's going to be a dark game. If rewatch that trailer right now, like AJ posted a second ago. Yeah, rewatch it. It's going to be a dark game.
Hey, we'll see, man.
I hope it is, at least.
We'll see, bro. Man,
it's gonna be like Zelda 2. It's gonna be called The Adventure of Ganon.
I see it, Mike. what's that CDI game? Quest of
Faces of Evil.
Yeah.
Wanda Gamelon.
Yeah, that CDI. Oh my goodness, that would be trash.
Man, E3.
Mike Ridge,
us,
thanks
man.
For subscribing, Mike.
Hey, something they need to announce is a new library for the Switch Online.
Yeah, that's what I was saying. Yeah. Like Nintendo 64.
Nintendo 64, Game Boy Advance, or...
Yeah, that's what I said.
I don't think that's necessary if they reveal some
heavy
hitter
games.
I'd
be hyped for that, though.
I'd be hyped, though, but I don't think it's necessary if they have good games.
Yeah, I know AJ liked that 64 game, so...
64 games are fire.
That'd be dope.
It ain't necessary.
That would be dope. But...
I was playing
Ocarina of
Time last night.
I want new games. I want achievements, Nintendo.
Yeah,
we
all do.
That ain't gonna happen.
I know, man. Yeah, I don't think Nintendo's about that, man.
It's too late for that.
They're too like family friendly.
If Nintendo does like achievements at this point, it's like, why are you like solely in the party? It's 2021 and achievements started since what, 2006 or 7 like that, and it's still messing out.
They started. They started before that on PC. I've been having achievements on PC for a long time.
You think you really
wow,
that's
advertised to Alan?
Never gonna happen.
Steam has had achievements, bro.
Yeah,
no, I'm saying Nintendo's never gonna have achievements.
I think Stadia
just
started.
I'm just saying
Stadia
Steam
started.
Had them way before everybody is what I'm saying. So it's old school technology. It's not new. It's nothing new.
Yeah. I know, man.
Nothing new.
Now the Steam achievements might not be as extravagant as the console ones, the way they pop up and stuff.
But they still have it.
They're still there.
Yeah. It hooks you into their platform. Well, it helps.
And it gets you playing the game more, you know what I'm saying? Because it's fun to get these achievements, you know, just pop up in your screen and you feel something accomplished, you know? It may be nothing, but it's something that you're accomplishing in the game.
Yeah.
There's a lot of times I've done things in games that I wouldn't have done otherwise just to get the achievement.
Yeah.
Like, went out of my way to do extra stuff to get the achievement that I wouldn't have probably done if there was no achievement.
Yeah. The, like, platinum game, you explore the game more, man. Yeah. but it's gonna be fun. Fun. In 1 hour.
I thought it was another couple minutes.
Let's
go.
Bro, we're 1 hour away. I need somebody to type a one in the chat. 1 hour. 1 hour, 4 minutes. So it's pretty much 1 hour, man. We 1 hour away.
Yeah, almost an hour.
Yeah. Ah, Nintendo. My Nintendo. Hey, we're at 169 likes. Need 30 people to give the stream a thumbs up. Let's get it over 200 likes, bro. Let's do it, bro. I see the ones in the chat. OB, I see you, Bucks. Yo, 56 platinums. Good stuff, Spike. Yo, who said OB?
That was me, AJ.
What up? What up, AJ?
For your internet, like when you're streaming and stuff, you got a good upload, right? Is it or got, great up? Great upload, I got it. Or how does that work?
I got 1,000 up, 1,000 down, bro. Business grade.
Dang, bro. Yeah, I'm gonna need to get that, bro. Let me hold that real quick.
Yeah, man. Gotta make sure them streams smooth, bro.
I need to get that, bro, man.
When you do streams like you do, how many uploads do you need to have like a quality stream?
I don't even know.
I don't think you have to have that, best to have
That's the only one that you know.
That's right, Johnny. But I don't know like what's the minimum. I don't know.
Well, the problem is,
I just go
some
for
people don't.
I
some
go
people
for the
don't
maximum.
Have that available. That's the problem. Some people don't have that available in their area. Like even me, I'm in the city.
Yeah, some people
city,
don't have it in their tri-state area yet.
Well, I'm in the city, and even in the city where I'm at, I'm in a big city too.
Yeah.
I'm in the capital of California.
Yeah.
But for some reason, where I'm at, they don't have, they own, like Comcast locked down our whole area, and Comcast don't offer, even with their gigabit package, they don't offer, they offer 1,000 down, but they only give you 40 up.
Oh, okay. Yeah. Some
places
don't
have
it. And
that's because it's cable. It's not Ethernet. It's coaxial.
Yeah.
So they use different types of nodes and different type of technology, but supposedly they're saying that Comcast next year they're coming out with something where they're gonna do like a hybrid fiber. So like the fiber lines are gonna run to the node, and then it's gonna come off that. So it's gonna help. Like supposedly we're gonna get 1,000 down, 1,000 up, but that's not gonna come until sometime next year.
Fiber than me.
There you go.
Stout knows it better than me. I don't know how to explain it to you, Johnny, but it's not really fake. It's just they're running the real fiber to the node, and then the node is supplying the power, because remember, it still has to run through coaxial, because that's how they run their, unless they, the only way they could eliminate that is if they run fiber to everyone's house. But you know how much money they would have to spend?
Yeah, I don't know, like, about any of that.
They would have to spend a lot of money. Yeah. Because they'd have to rerun everything underground. They're not going to do that.
Yeah.
But it's all good.
They barely want to go out and help people out.
Bro. But yeah, hopefully next year they fix that so I can get my 1,000 up, 1,000 down. Yep. Yeah, I don't even have up. I mean, I have 40 upload. But I mean, when I was streaming 40 upload, it was fine. I mean, I think just have to set your settings right.
That's right.
Know,
yeah.
Just kinda just
yeah. It. Yeah. Your settings have to be right. Moon slash.
You were having a storm yesterday, AJ.
Chilling, man.
Yeah, hey. but it's been happening lately too. Hey, notice, man, like, even with the storm.
Hey, but real quick, Moose.
So I'm gonna have to try to.
Now go ahead, AJ.
No, I was just saying I'm gonna have to talk to my internet.
There you go. Moon slash, any games from Nintendo you want to see, bro?
One and only game I want to see is Fire Emblem, the new Fire Emblem game.
Fire Emblem, I do want a Fire Emblem game. Okay,
I'm not gonna lie, I do want another Fire Emblem.
You're the first one that I've heard say they want a new Fire Emblem.
Nah, it's well overdue now. So the last one was released around 2019, I think.
They had the Three Houses.
Yeah, Three Houses was such a good game.
Yeah. I never beat it, man. I didn't finish it.
Oh, you need to finish it.
Yeah, it's a good game. Incredible. It was a good game. Yeah.
Incredible.
But
oh yeah, Three Houses was so good.
It's Metroid Prime 4 for me or nothing. it's either A or F, Nintendo. I'ma tweet that out.
there's one game.
Ain't no big games, bro. What'd you say?
Hey Obi, how about Bayonetta 3?
I'm not that hyped for Bayonetta 3, man. It's Metroid Prime 4, bro.
But what's happened to Bayonetta 3 though?
It's a, they did that one teaser, then nothing else.
They tried it. They said it was COVID.
Man.
They said they didn't have as much development time as they wanted or something.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah, COVID really screwed everything up though. That was the problem.
I mean, yeah, to be honest, it didn't really do it with Nintendo, just Nintendo either. It did it with a lot of Sony games, a lot of Xbox.
Sony games, Xbox. Yeah, it's not just Nintendo. It did it with every game
development
company.
The development times got really messed up with it. Like, there's a lot of games that got pushed back that shouldn't have got pushed back. Like, a lot of stuff.
Oh, we would have had God of War Ragnarok by now.
But, you know, I don't even know if we would have God of War Ragnarok.
At least gameplay.
They would have stacked too many games in the first year, man. I think that's too much.
We've at least seen something, you know what I mean?
Spider-Man, Horizon, and God of War in 1 year? That's a lot. That's too much, man.
Is it, though, if it's just, like, shorter games?
That's pulling a Nintendo 2017, and then you have nothing
and
after
then,
that.
Yeah, you got to pace it out, man.
If you guys would have had all three of those, you wouldn't have had anything for the next couple years.
Yeah, man.
Maybe not. I mean, they got a lot of new studios now that are doing new original.
Yeah,
like,
but you see how new studios work out, though. They don't always bring out the heat.
Sometimes
they can be unpredictable.
The past few years, they've been bringing
What new studio?
What's up, Lord Valorant?
They got Deviation Games is the one I'm excited for.
Yeah,
but what have they brought, though? You know what I'm saying? I'm not saying they're not good.
The head of the studio made the entire Black Ops Zombie storyline.
For what game?
I mean, that's not that exciting.
Yo, BMO, what's up?
What's up, everybody else
in the chat I ain't see? We here, man. We here. We waiting for the Nintendo Direct. Give the stream a thumbs up. We need 20 First more likes Black to get Ops it to 100. To 200.
And World War Zombies.
Hey, I'm asking YouTube chat. What games do y'all want to see today, YouTube chat? I want to see what games the YouTube chat says. Let's see, man. It's time to see what Nintendo.
Someone said they want a new Punch-Out.
Bro, yes. I'll take a new Punch-Out. I would get a Punch-Out day one.
Labo VR Punch-Out?
No. A real Punch-Out.
They got to put Mike Tyson in the Punch-Out.
Bro, that would be so lit if they put Mike Tyson back in Punch-Out, bro. That would be crazy.
He said already in an interview. I watched an interview of him recently, and he said he was waiting on a phone call do another punch out.
Bro, that would be crazy.
They put Floyd Mayweather.
Oh yeah, they could do that.
They have Logan Paul in there. I would die, bro.
Hey, Honest said,
I would die.
He comes out with the Charizard card and everything.
Someone said Pokemon Stadium.
Pokemon Stadium, man. That's right, Al Bundy.
Someone said a double dragon.
What if Logan Paul
double dragon?
The,
yo, what's up, Organized? He said double dragon.
In the Legend Arceus.
Double dragon was old school, beat him up. Pokken 2? The Pokken Tournament was dope. I like Pokken Tournament.
It was all right, but I'd rather see Pokemon Stadium than Pokken.
Yeah. My dude Alan say Jake Paul is Mac.
Jake Paul as Mac. Jake Mac.
A new Star Fox game. That would be dope.
Bro, I wish they could do Banjo-Kazooie LMG, but I don't think they can because I think Microsoft got that unlocked, to be honest.
Bro, yeah. They're going to have to make it.
Even though Microsoft ain't doing nothing with it.
It's dead. Man, Bucks, don't stop.
That doesn't make sense.
Bro,
That doesn't make sense to me. I will admit that doesn't make sense to me because I don't understand why they can't. Microsoft missed the opportunity. They could make a... And the thing is, they have the hardware, so they can make a... Imagine how good they can make a Banjo-Kazooie that looked like Ratchet & Clank.
That's what I was right about to say. When I played Ratchet & Clank, in the back of my mind, I'm like, this could be Banjo-Kazooie, bro.
It could.
They're missing the mark with that one.
I know,
beautiful
game
to play, too.
There's nothing we can do about it, man. They want to go, like you said, they want to go the route of... Which I agree with you. They want to go the route with Game Pass. So unfortunately, they spend a lot of their time focused on that and not as much focused on the actual game development because they're just worried about getting deals.
Or maybe it's a case that the developers is not good enough.
Maybe.
No, I don't think it's that. I don't think it's that at all because remember, bro, everyone seems to forget about the 360 era when Microsoft had all the first party banger exclusives. So the thing is, they have the talent, man. They're putting all their resources into, they're not on the 360 wave no more. They're on the Game Pass wave because you've seen how much I proved to you guys last night when I looked up how much Game Pass makes. Now I know that some of it's overhead, But yeah, they're still making a lot of money off of it. That's why they're going that route, because in the long run, they're going to end up like Netflix, man. They're going to look how much money Netflix makes.
Yeah, yeah.
Microsoft saw the dollar signs, bro. They were like, oh, we can make all this money off of Game Pass. Like, why
if
not?
If they keep it up,
Obi.
We'll see, man. We'll see. Yo, who just said Obi? Yo, what's up, Pop?
You like Godfall, right?
Oh, yeah, yeah. I like Godfall.
There's a stream going on right now at E3. They're showing the Godfall team showing off the first expansion.
Oh, that's dope. I might re-download it. I deleted it after
fire,
I beat it.
Fire and Dark. It's got a new in-game mode, too. So after you beat the game, you get a new mode.
Oh, that's dope. Hey, Broken can help me carry me to get the Platinum. Broken, let's Platinum Godfall.
Hey, he's typing in chat now.
Broken
said, yeah, Broken said Platinum in Godfall was no joke.
Broken said, I ain't helping. So bro, I beat that last boss in like 2 minutes with Broken.
No, Platinuming it, though. Not. Yeah, you have to do like some. There's one of one of the trophies in there is like really hard. I can't remember which one he was telling me, but it was one of them was like extremely hard for him to get. It took him a while.
Don't talk about if
you're doing it by yourself.
Tell you platinum Minecraft.
No. It was like Broken. What was that one you said that was real, real hard to get? What trophy was it? I remember you telling me. There's like one that's real, real hard. He's gonna say it right now.
Hey, but one game I might go back. This is my platinum schedule. I'm gonna platinum Ratchet and Clank. I'm gonna platinum Sackboy. I might go back and platinum Demon Souls remake, man. I might go back.
Good luck with that.
Demon Souls. Yeah, it's gonna be tough, but I think after you, because I've already beaten the game and my character is OP, and so going back doing some of those stages is gonna be easy, man. Easier. I'm not gonna say it's gonna be easy because I get
No. It's not that. Isn't there like some ones where I don't know
that are tedious? Are. Yeah. I gotta look and see. I don't know yet.
You said if they don't reveal Metroid Prime 4, it's an F no matter what they do.
I'm just putting pressure on Nintendo. Nah, Splatoon 3 has a good showing. I have to say, I got burnt out by Splatoon, man. I was such a Splatoon head. I don't even play Splatoon anymore, man. Splatoon 3 has a
good... You used to be really big on Splatoon.
Yeah, I think I played it too much.
I can't blame you because, like you said this before, you know, Splatoon 2 felt like almost like Splatoon 1.
It
nothing
did.
Has changed, you know?
It did.
Splatoon 3 is going to be different from the first trailer, at least.
From the first trailer. The only difference I saw was they launching from up top from the beginning.
Yeah.
But once they got down and they showed the gameplay, it looked the same, man. It like the same game. Just different maps. So I'm hoping they do something else, man. I don't know, man. Like,
I'm still gonna pick it up. I think it's gonna be a fun game.
I wanted like a graphical overhaul, like have the Inklings like a big fat Inkling that's slow like a tank. Like they could everything just seems the same, man.
Maybe they don't want to show too much in that teaser for the game.
Yeah, maybe. Yeah, so we'll see. I'm still not. I mean, at the end of the day, I'm gonna buy Splatoon 3 day one. So yeah. I'm still buy it, but man,
they don't matter. I'm gonna buy it. Yeah.
I just wish they would do something more with it, man.
What if? Hey, if they come out during that, they reveal a Twitch Pro, and then they're like,
if they announce like Metro Prime 4, hey, let me. I'm gonna get my hype hat when the stream about to start. I'm gonna have it next to me. When they announce Metro Prime 4 hype hat is coming on, bro. The hype hat will come on.
What if they announce F-Zero, a new F-Zero game?
Hype hat will come on for F-Zero. F-Zero. Metroid Prime 4, a new Star Fox. Hype hat will come on.
Hey, Obi, remember that place in Demon's Souls where that shot all the arrows on the bridge and you went around? Remember?
Yeah. But I figured out. Go ahead.
One of the trophies is you got to cross the bridge without getting hit by an arrow.
Oh, man. Man, like arrows coming from everywhere, bro. I figured out. I could get that.
Oh, this is the one. Yeah, this is the one, Obi, that he said is hard in Godfall. Ascendant. You have to reach Trial 20 in the Ascendant Tower of Trials.
Broken. The hardest trophy he's ever earned.
Broken. We could do that together, Broken.
No, it's really hard.
Me, you, and Lake Show. It's not a single player trophy. We could do it in multiplayer.
It took Broken like 3 weeks.
Because he probably did it by himself. But if they OP, they could carry me to do it. Forget that.
Obi, if they announce pre-orders, if they show Switch Pro and they're like, Switch Pro pre-orders are live and starting after the show, are you gonna run down to GameStop and go?
Oh, you better believe it, bro. Yeah, I'm making a post. I'm gonna live stream myself. driving
anyone
down.
Anyone ever played Destiny? You guys played Destiny?
I'm one of the big Destiny fans, man. It's like my favorite.
Okay, so I'm not big on Destiny. I have Platinum in Destiny, right? Star and the Fox. Hardest trophy, because I used to be like really into it. The hardest trophy I ever got in my life one was in Destiny. And the first one. The hardest trophy I ever got in my life in Destiny was you had to complete a hard mode raid with your whole fire team without anybody dying.
That's impossible. That's almost impossible.
No, we got it though.
Yeah, that's one of the
finally. Very difficult. It was the hardest trophy I ever got in my life.
Yeah.
You know they brought really, Shadow Blaster back for Destiny 2.
Yeah, I never played it. I never got into Destiny.
We played it like I put like thousands, I'm talking thousands of hours into it. So we finally ended up getting it after a while.
Hey, well, we did 198 likes. I need two people to give the stream a thumbs up. Let's pass 200 likes. Go ahead, Bucks.
Not in here yet.
What?
Broken, you're a hater, Broken. What'd you say, Johnny?
Chivalry.
Oh, Chivalry too. Did I buy it? Not yet, Johnny.
Is that PC only?
No, it's on PlayStation and Xbox too.
That just came out?
Yeah.
Is it cross-gen? Hey, I ain't buying no cross-gen games, bro. If the game's still coming out... No. Let me change that. Because Horizon is cross-gen. It has to be lit, bro. It has to be a dope game, man.
Yeah, but how about Guardians of the Galaxy?
Guardians... That game looked like trash, bro. That game looked like trash. It looked like... I mean, I'm hyped because it's Guardians of the Galaxy. I like the movies. But that game looked like a Nintendo Switch game, bro.
It don't look graphically good.
What's wrong with that? If you play Nintendo Switch,
bro, AJ, Switch third party games trash. TRASH. Hey.
Obi,
yeah, what's up, bro?
Do you agree with this?
Did it start yet? Hey,
what's
everybody.
Up? What's up, Kiki? No, it hasn't started yet. We have 47 minutes. It starts in 47 minutes.
Obi, would you agree with this statement? If the only big announcement was they're adding themes to the Switch, were they still winning three?
Bro, that would be trash, bro. Bro, we're asking for no. Xbox would win if they just do themes. Because check this out. For each PlayStation game, there's a theme. You highlight over a PlayStation game, boom, that entire theme and music comes up. And so... Sony is running laps around them. If you're talking about just themes, bro, they got a theme for every game.
Yeah, but then the moment Xbox started doing that, the first thing people are gonna say, oh, they're copying.
No,
that's the problem.
I mean, but everybody have themes. Themes is common, bro.
Everyone has themes, yeah.
You know, one thing I don't understand.
You know how people are.
Sometimes. Yeah.
One thing I just don't understand how the Switch 2 doesn't have themes when the 3DS had themes. Yeah. I don't understand why Nintendo's taking so long.
I know, man.
I don't know. Maybe they're going to be like 4K main menu with themes on Switch Pro.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, we'll see, man.
They're definitely going to show Shin Megami Tensei 5. 100%.
Shin Megami Tensei?
5, yeah. They're going to show it because it's coming out this year.
Oh. Well, maybe if it's a game we've seen stuff on, or have we seen anything from it yet?
What's that?
Yeah, there's been a teaser trailer for Shin Megami Tensei 5.
We'll probably see that. We'll probably see a new trailer, but I'm kind of like, if a game's already got a trailer, I'd expect it just to be like, we'll talk about it in the treehouse or something. But that, since it's only a teaser, now we'll probably see a full trailer or something.
Man. Nintendo, don't disappoint. Don't disappoint.
Yeah. Come on.
My expectations are low.
My expectations are high. I got to give them high expectations.
Yeah.
High. High. I want them to blow it out the water, Nintendo.
They've had 2 years to set this direct up.
Yeah. I am
not. They weren't, man. It's going to be a bunch of Wii U ports, man.
I can't, bro. That's all I felt like the Switch generation has been, man. Wii U ports.
I'm fine with that. Wii U and 3DS ports. Fine, as long as they're quality games.
I mean, the Wii U games were lit, but I had a Wii U, man. I had a Wii U, Nintendo. Give us more. We want more.
I never had a Wii U, so...
Okay, so you good.
Yeah.
You're so lucky you.
I remember Obi when he was on that Wii U. That's when I first saw your channel.
Yeah, Wii U was lit,
you're
man.
You Wii U.
Yeah.
Yeah, the Wii U background.
All right, I think that's where it all started. Like, I started watching Obi like in the Wii U era.
Yeah, man.
And there's Obi-Wan plays tracks
Yeah. Oh yeah. 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 We had them fire trucks.
Get the iPhone headphones. Oh, the iPhone man. Little earbuds.
Oh yeah. The time when they used.
Oh yeah. 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 That's fact. Yeah. I still got it. I might bring them out. My dude's Bo Hall said Wave Racer. Wave Racer was lit on the 64, bro.
And 1080 as well. 1080 was good as well.
Yeah, yeah.
Obi, you gotta give Nintendo good luck. You gotta sing your Paper Mario Color Splash song.
Hey, Paper Mario Color Splash. That's right. Y'all be hating. We getting cash. There's a timer right here. 43 minutes.
It's over now.
Here we go, man.
Nintendo, just don't disappoint. Just don't disappoint.
That's what I'm saying, man. We got the seconds counting down now.
I wouldn't mind a new wave race, to be honest.
What'd you say?
I'm like, yeah.
I wouldn't mind a new wave race, to be honest.
Yeah, yep. A modern day wave race. There's so many possibilities Nintendo could do, man. Bustin' Justin, I said nobody wants a Pokemon Stadium. Nah, I'm good on Pokemon. I've never been big on Pokemon.
Too much Pokemon.
Nah,
they reveal. Yeah.
Unless it's like, unless they make it like Gale of Darkness was like a full art, like a full RPG, and has the stadium battles and stuff.
There you go.
Who do you guys think is gonna be the Smash Fighter they reveal?
Smash Fighter, I have no idea. You never
know. Who would you want if you could pick?
I really don't have like a Crash Bandicoot. Crash.
I think Crash gotta be it, right?
Yeah, that's what I would think, man.
At this point, I don't care who gets out of this match. As long as it's a fighter that, you know, plays good and
as long
it's not a boring character, then I wouldn't mind.
As long as they don't have a sword and a shield, bro. Too many Fire Emblem characters.
Too many sword fighters.
Too many sword fighters.
Are we getting
bro.
A new Pokemon? New Pokemon fighter.
Smash has turned into anime, super anime brothers.
It'd be cool if they did a Doom guy.
Hey man, it's not their fault they're all stars.
We get an anime sword fighter. We go and get 10 minutes on Sharingan, 5 minutes on Mario Golf, 10 on Splatoon. They'll get Breath of the Wild 2, and then they're gonna announce Blue and Yellow Toad are coming. The cardboard Mario Kart.
Yeah, you know they're gonna show Mario Golf just because the game's about to launch. They're gonna do some promotion for it.
I think it'll just be a treehouse.
No more than 1 minute on Mario Golf, bro.
Yeah, I was about to say the same thing. No more than 1 minute, please. That better not be the main highlight.
No, man.
That better not be the main
highlight. That's the main highlight.
That would be so funny if the whole direct was Mario Golf and then, like, the last thing. And we have one more thing for you. Yeah. And everybody's, like, hype, and then it's a Mario Golf DLC.
DLC. Pink and purple golf balls.
They'll be like, you can purchase. Starting next week, you can purchase the golden tennis racket Joy-Con accessory.
Golf clubs. I know.
That'll be the day that I'll be like, I'm never asking off from work, off for E3 ever again.
I know, bro.
Man, hey, I don't think it's gonna be like a meme. I don't think this direct's gonna be good. I don't think so. I think it's gonna be trash.
You think what's gonna be good?
The direct. I don't think it's gonna be that great.
Oh man, Moon. Man, you get me nervous, bro. You get me nervous.
Think about it. You guys just said it. They're gonna spend time talking about Mario Golf. What else is there? Splatoon 3, probably.
Splatoon 3.
So they're talking about Mario Golf.
Oh, yeah, they did reveal Splatoon 3. So we know that
Mario Strikers and Leo.
Never had E3 where they talk about games that are coming out within the coming week or month. Yeah. I mean, they always do. Gotta market it, like Obi said.
Hey, a Mario Strikers would be lit, man. If they had a Mario Strikers game, that would be lit. Why do I have my I didn't even change my gift. I got my 2K gift.
Oh my god.
We'll see, man.
Yeah, I'm not even gonna stream the event. I'm just gonna watch it because I'm having internet issues and it's like, sucks.
How funny would it be if they announced that games will be coming out on the PC?
Which what game? Oh, if Nintendo, bro, that would
just
be
randomly, just randomly.
Bro,
just
the random. Internet would go crazy. You talking about
Nintendo X, Nvidia?
Bro, PC dudes would lose their mind, bro.
Because PlayStation's doing it, Xbox doing it, so Nintendo might jump on it.
No, I don't.
You never know. You never know. You never know.
Yeah, you're right, but I just don't see Nintendo doing it. But that would be crazy if they do it.
I never saw PlayStation doing it.
You're right. You're right.
Never know.
Yep. Anything can happen.
It's extra money for Nintendo right there. They put their games on PC. Is,
yeah. And people will buy it. People will buy their games on PC.
Oh, facts.
People would, yeah.
You know how many people illegally get their games on PC? Yeah, man. Yeah, they would sell. It would sell, man.
It's gonna be weird seeing Doug Bowser doing the talking.
Doug Bowser doing what?
But most of the talking, you know, like what Reggie would do, because now this is his first E3 as president.
That's, hey, Pot, that picture's funny, bro. That they got a cross in the church.
It's a church, like, yeah.
Yeah, but it's a Smash logo.
It is the Smash logo.
That's funny.
That's where I'm going. I'm going to go there.
Hey,
I'm
thanks for subscribing, Starscream.
Worship almighty Reggie.
Reggie, peace and me. That's funny.
That must have been dope, though, if you were meeting Reggie, OB.
Oh, that was fire, bro. He recognized me, man. He be watching my videos, man.
Oh, yeah, OB. Yeah, Reggie's a big fan. Remember when he said, I got to go play Animal Crossing on my Nintendo 3DS? Yeah, he went back in there. He was watching OB.
Yeah, shout out to Reggie Fils-Aimé, bro. Reggie, Reggie ever run for president, I'll be his vice VP or on his cabinet or something. Make me the secretary of gaming, bro. Create a new position. Electro, thanks for subscribing.
Hey, man, the Senate just passed the thing, so now they're getting more parts out for PlayStations and Xboxes, so.
Yeah, we'll see, man. They need to crank it up. Turn it up. We're at 220 likes. Give the stream a thumbs up. Let's get it to 250 likes. Nintendo Direct is about to go down 37 minutes. It's about to be lit. It's about to be
yes,
hype.
Sir.
Can't wait.
I was playing Metro Prime Hunters, the DS. Man, that game is so cool, man. They need to modernize that.
I never played Prime Hunters, man. I heard good things about it.
Man, it's so cool, bro.
That's dope, man.
And it had a multiplayer where you got to like fight like
the
different hunters in the game,
bro.
That would be amazing for a modern port of that.
That's I keep saying that AJ Metro Prime 4 needs to have multiplayer, man. They need to have multiplayer, man. Because you got, just remember Metro Prime 3. They had the different bounty hunters with different abilities and stuff. That would be so dope, man.
Yep. Come on. It'd be like almost like an Overwatch Paladins kind of thing. You got different, like, hunters with different abilities.
Yeah, that would be lit, man. Nintendo.
Yeah, it's
the closer we get to the time, the more nervous I get.
I'm kind of nervous too. I'm like,
wait, man, you're not only there for yourself. I'm nervous too. I don't know what Nintendo's gonna show, man, because just the fact that there hasn't been any leaks coming out, it's just like, what is Nintendo gonna show?
Yeah, you're right. Because there hasn't been any. Leak information.
Well, yeah. That's almost leaked. Better to me.
Yeah, so this is going to be
because that way we won't get spoiled.
Usually,
now,
there's
keep
a...
in mind, though, guys.
Go ahead.
Oh, I'm sorry. No, I didn't mean to interrupt. Go ahead.
No, I didn't say usually there's like one or two leaks. Nothing has leaked from this Direct.
That's nothing. Good. Yeah.
So.
Yeah, nothing.
Maybe people are scared that you're going to get fired.
I don't see, man.
Oh, yeah, that's true. Because they probably only say certain things to certain people just to make sure that they know, okay, well, we only said it to this person so we know who it is.
Yeah, so if it's leaked, it's you.
That's what I'm saying. Yeah. And the 10 ninjas going to come get you.
Yeah, they don't play around, man.
And then and then also keep in mind, they did that one time where they revealed Metroid Samus Returns on a treehouse. Uh-huh. So we never know. It's a 3-hour treehouse. Maybe they might reveal something in the treehouse.
You know what, AJ? I was talking about that. What I want, kind of, what would be really cool. I know everyone's talking about porting all these old Metroid games, which I guess would be all right. But what I really want, honestly, because I know we're not getting Metroid Prime 4 this year, right? We know that. That's not coming this year.
Uh-huh.
So what I think I really want is at least a new Metroid, like, 2D platformer game on the Switch. That would be fire.
Yeah,
bro.
Metroid, like, Metroid, you know, Metroid 5.
That what?
Or Metroid Samus Returns 2.
Yeah, I'll take that.
Yeah, but Samus, that's true. Yeah, that's true. Well, the thing is, look at this. So the people that made Samus Returns, the Mercury Steam, they actually pitched to Nintendo originally. They wanted a Metroid Fusion remake. Nintendo shot that down, but they still wanted them to work on a remake of Metroid 2. But the cool thing is, you get to use the fusion suit in that game, Samus Returns.
Right.
So okay. I'm thinking that this was kind of like a test to see, okay, let's see what kind of game they can make to make a sequel to Metroid Fusion. Because I think there's probably the most ideal. Yeah, because they wanted to do a fusion game.
So
the fact that they did a quality 2D game, they're probably the most likely candidate to make a Metroid sequel, like a 2D sequel.
Yeah, and here's the thing. There has been rumors of a possible 2D Metroid game. Because even when Samus Returns came out on the 3DS, the Switch was already out. And I was like, why didn't they just have a Switch version of this game?
On the Switch?
Right.
As well, man. So.
And here's the thing, too.
Probably get that now. Go ahead.
Remember how dope the 3DS library was? Nintendo can do so many things.
Oh, yeah.
The thing is, this is a home console, but at the same time,
it's a handheld.
This is also a handheld, too.
Yeah.
So they could really do a lot of dope things with this handheld, man.
Yeah.
Why don't we see, like, a Zelda? What's it? Triforce Heroes or something. Like a new Triforce Heroes.
Yeah.
Or a new... And then we could do multiplayer online with Triforce.
Yes. Because
now they have online, right?
Yes.
Like, you could do something like that.
Yes.
Like, I don't understand why they're missing all these opportunities, man.
Yeah.
I mean, they'll probably do that for the release on the mobile.
I know, right, Mooney? He's on the phone.
I'm gonna head off the voice chat, guys, because I'm actually gonna react with my friends right now.
All right, no worries, bro. All right. I'm being here for about 20 more minutes at the 10-minute mark. We're just gonna laser in on the direct, man.
Yeah, Buck. Still fully released on the mobile or something.
You're right, Moon.
that's how backwards Nintendo is.
Yeah, that is unpredictable.
That
man.
Is true. It's unfortunate. I mean,
we want Mario Kart 9. Nope. Here's some Mario Kart Tour iPhone DLC.
You know what it is too? Is like I think we think that like Nintendo's like purposely messing up, but no, there's no way. Cause you gotta remember, Nintendo's smart. They've been around a long time.
What's up, Darcy?
I think what it's turned into, unfortunately, is more of a money thing.
Yeah,
they do what is smart and what makes money.
Business.
Anymore. They don't do. Yeah. Unfortunately, they don't do what the gamers always want.
Yeah.
Because they're more concerned with what's gonna make them the
cheddar. And think about it, the Switch is still killing it. Month after month, they still killing it, even without giving the
Oh, they're almost—they're about to reach 100 million Switches.
Yeah, they're like 86 million right now, bro. Yo, yeah. Thugs, what's up, Thugs?
86 million.
Yeah, so they're gonna catch up to the PS4, bro.
Yeah.
GameStop's supposed to be selling some in store too now.
Yeah,
oh, yeah. They just got a big fat restock. Nintendo just sent them a huge restock.
Yeah.
So,
Who's buying these Switches, though?
Right.
Bro,
I mean,
everyone, bro.
Yeah,
so
everyone.
Many casual. You have to remember. Yeah. And this is what I always try to tell people in here, and I tell people in my other Discord too.
Uh-huh.
We have to remember, all these people in Discord, we're all hardcore gamers, okay?
Yeah.
I'm speaking to this because I have a lot of family. All my brothers and cousins all work construction.
Yeah.
So they're like casual gamers. They're not really technical guys. They're not. Yeah. They don't have gaming PCs. They're mostly outside doing stuff, but they game every once in a while. Uh-huh. Those type of people, they're late on stuff a lot. Mm-hmm. So they might just got a Switch or might just go out and get one just because they saw Mario Kart. That's why Mario Kart's still selling. That's why the Switch still selling.
Yeah.
Cause there's a lot of casual gamers out there, bro. That are late on stuff. It's just how it is.
Like my brothers,
people still having kids.
My brothers,
exactly.
My brother's wife, she is not a gamer at all. And he is calling me, asking me about what Animal Crossing game was, what on the Switch. And so they're just like appealing to like just everybody.
Yeah, exactly. They appeal to those crowds that are just like that, like Obi's brother that are just like casual, more casual.
No, his wife.
His wife's more casual.
And for her, the Switch is just an Animal Crossing machine. That's all she's playing.
And that's fine. Nintendo doesn't care about that because guess what? They just sold a console and they sold Animal Crossing.
Yep.
So it's for them. It's
AOB.
They made money. Jonas, yo.
I'm so nervous that I just dropped a brick in a toilet.
TMI. But I hear you, Jonas.
No, guys.
Hey, Nintendo Live is Nintendo is live. There's no countdown anymore.
On my screen, there's still a countdown. I'll refresh it.
Refresh it.
Yeah, but you're
it's live.
Oh, they're doing a pre-show? Are they doing a pre-show?
Nah, it's just a stream. Just a stream went live. Yeah, the stream just went live.
30 minutes! Let's go, guys!
Yeah, let me put my timer on. I gotta put my timer back because it's not on the thing anymore.
Oh my gosh, that would be fire though. A Grand Theft Auto. That's not gonna happen though. Kaleem just put Grand Theft Auto Vice City and Amiibo.
And my countdown stopped. Let me put it. You said Grand Theft Auto.
Oh, the
what?
Trilogy. Grand Theft Auto Trilogy 1, 2, and 3 with the Vice City Amiibo. That'd be fire, but I don't think it's gonna happen.
No, so, it's fake. It's clearly fake.
Yeah.
The problem is
Amiibo. That would be funny though. Click. But go ahead, Bucks.
Nintendo's too family friendly to do all that.
Yeah. Here we go. It's getting close. Oh, let me get my headband. Hold on. I'll be getting closer, but I'm not putting it on yet.
Oh, I thought you said you weren't gonna put
they
it.
They gotta earn it.
Okay, if they you gotta get it close to you, and if they say something crazy, you gotta put it on.
Oh yeah, that's what I'm gonna do, Bucks. They gotta say something crazy, man.
What happened with Capcom last night? I heard it.
Like,
and for content, Obi, the best content ever. Uh-huh. If the direct is trash, you gotta burn your hype hat live on
stage. I know, right? I'm setting it on fire. Hey,
that'd be crazy.
Where's my? I got a fire gif. I could just put the hype hat in it.
That'd be funny, bro. Like a cauldron. Put it in a cauldron.
Burn it.
You'll do like those animated ones. Yeah, like fake ones.
There we go. Nintendo, let me use this. I want to use this today, Nintendo. Here we go.
Oh, Obi had too many disappointing directs. He got sad.
Man, I know, man.
No, you know when it ended for you, Obi? I remember when it ended for you. When Nintendo didn't have a direct for like 100 and something days, that's when you fell up. That's when you were like, all right.
That was it, man. And no games. There was like Animal Crossing. That's it. I'm like, man, all
right. He's like, I'm done. I'm like, and it's not like you're not a supporter, because how many Switches do you have in your house?
I'm about five Switches, bro. And I'm about to buy the Switch Pro. It's going to be six, bro. Come on, man. Yeah.
You're definitely supporting. And you got, and you were one of the first people to get the 1 terabyte.
Oh, yeah. I got the 1 terabyte. Card. I just got
You bought pretty much every Switch game ever that came out.
Like, I just bought Monster Hunter Rise. I got the Rise Pro controller. Come on, man.
How many Pro controllers do you have?
At least 8.
It's hot.
At least 8.
8 Pro controllers.
Yeah, man.
Bro,
I got
8 PS5 controllers, sorry.
I got 7. Yeah, 7. I know, man. I need to stop.
How you good?
I need to chill with these.
Keep going, mate. Keep going.
Nah. Yeah, I can't help it, man. I like getting. I just always been a gamer, man. So
I only got.
I don't
3.
Think it's ever stopped. Hey, 3 is more than many.
Right.
You really only need 1, but.
No, I had to get that black one though.
Oh yeah, the black one, that midnight black. But the red one looks, hey, Keek, I'm telling you, the red one is good.
The red one does look good.
Yeah, red one is fire. It's fire. It is.
Yeah, I saw when you unboxed it, I was like, wow.
Yeah, the red one is lit, man. All right.
Anyhow, Nintendo announced games broken. I would laugh so much.
Bro. Bro, that would break the internet mood. That would break the internet if Nintendo announced their games coming to PC.
Like legacy games coming out to PC, like Mario Kart 8 and stuff.
That would be insane.
Maybe one day when they're like, when they decide to stop making physical hardware, maybe, but I don't think so.
Yeah, I don't know.
Hey, I'm gonna head out. I'm gonna head out, guys. I'll talk to you guys later.
All right, AJ. All right. It's almost time. 25 minutes.
Yeah, bro.
25 minutes.
Put a 25 in the chat.
I got a month of the OGC. Thugs, you will never beat me in Street Fighter. If you beat me once, it was a fluke.
Hey guys, I'll be back, but if I don't, I'll be watching your stream live.
All right, Kiki.
Yeah, I'm watching the stream live, but
25
I'm heading out
minutes, too. Yeah. All right, well, I'm going to just hop out the voice chat. If it's lit, I'll hop back in afterwards. Well, even if it's trash, I'll hop back in.
All right.
Rage.
Hey, have a good direct, anyway, everyone.
All right,
you too.
Here we go, ladies and gentlemen. The countdown, we're getting close to the time, 25 minutes. Give the stream a thumbs up. Nintendo Direct time. It's showtime. It's showtime. Let's go get it. Oh, we're at 230 likes. Let's get it to 250 likes. 20 people. I need 20 people watching the stream. Give the stream a thumbs up. Let's get it to 250 likes. Let's do it right now. And let's witness Nintendo be great. Nintendo, be great, Nintendo. Be great. They're great. Oh, man. Nervous. We nervous. For everyone, not for kids. Let's go. All right. So it's going to be a Nintendo Direct and a Treehouse Live after. Whoo. It's time. It's almost time. 23 minutes. Brandon with another $5. You the GOAT, Brandon. OB on the sixth biome. You're on the sixth biome. Let's go, Brandon. Anxious to beat Returnal, but will also be sad to see this one end. Thanks for all those Returnal live streams, bro. Returnal was so amazing, man. You got this, man. You made it to the sixth biome. I have to tell you this, Brandon. My first run through the sixth biome, I was like running past a lot of these enemies, but it does pay off to fight them. You got it, Brandon. You got it, Brandon. You got it, bro. Oh, Brandon, on the last boss, there are health on the floor behind you. Check. There's like multiple, like two or three large, syphilim. On the floor behind you on the final boss. A lot of people don't know that. But just check, run around on the floor behind you. If your health gets low, there's health on the floor. There's multiple. Like, I've seen like two or three behind you. People don't know that though. But you got it, bro. You got it. Hey, untrusted PS5 fanboy. They still haven't convinced me. Hold on, let me type this. All right. So, here we go. Oh. Time for the show. Hey. All right. It's time. Nintendo Direct Live. Hey, I need a couple people watching the stream to go and share the stream on Twitter, bro. Close. Hey, Hernan Cruz, thanks for subscribing. There's a share button below this video somewhere. Share this stream on Twitter. If you're not subscribed, click subscribe. Your name will appear live on stream. We're just ready, man. It's time. 21 minutes. It's time to go. It's time for Nintendo to show. I forgot I had this beat. Let's go. We're ready. All we can do is wait now, man. All we can do is just wait. Stream should be, well, it's gonna be Nintendo. Stranger of Paradise demo is fixed, Brian. Stop playing. Bro. It's working? Simulator, man, with the $5 euro. I'm going to re-download it. I'll try that game out later, man. Do you think that Nintendo going to show Switch Pro at first or at the end, watching from the UK, plus how to join your club as well, and how much a month. You could do it in the description of this video. It answers all those questions. Simulator Man, check the description of this video, and it'll show you how to join our dope community, man. But we'll be having a good time. Thanks for the €5. But definitely, you're welcome, bro. You're welcome. Welcome to join the OGC. I'll add you on PlayStation. You got a PlayStation. And we'll just have a fun time, man. So, and I'm not even Final Fantasy. I'm going to watch you complete that game. Hey, I can't wait. I'm going to play it tonight. I'm going to play it later today. I'll do that on my gaming channel. Obi-Wan Plays Gaming Championship. That's my gaming channel. I'll play some Strangers of Paradise later today, that Final Fantasy Origins. Final Fantasy on the NES, my favorite all-time game. I'm just hoping, fingers crossed, that they base the game off of like the locations you go to. All of that would be off of the original Final Fantasy game. So that's what I'm hoping, man. Sing the Pokemon rap. I don't even know the Pokemon rap. I mean, I know what it is, but I don't remember the words. Let's go. All right, what's up, everybody? Thanks for tuning in. 17 minutes, and thanks. We crushed 250 likes. The next goal is 300 likes. So if you're coming into the stream, you haven't given the stream a thumbs up, give it a thumbs up. The hype hat is right here. If Nintendo announces something hype, the hype hat will come on, bro. Let's go. All right, hold on. Oh, I'm on the wrong thing. Hold on. That's it. All right, we good. I was doing something else. Let's go, man. 16 minutes. It's almost time. It's almost time. Let's go. Let's go. Thanks for subscribing, Toya, who just subscribed. Also, make sure you subscribe to the channel. Let's go. If it ain't live, it ain't OB. Keto, what's up, bro? Hope you've been good, my guy. Mysterio graphics are only one part of a game. Yeah. They're going to show Metro Prime 4 and Bayonetta 3. Justin, they better show Metro Prime 4, bro. I don't want to hear otherwise, bro. They better show Metro Prime 4, bro. Metro Prime 4, I'm still holding out that they show the Switch Pro. I'm still holding out that they might show the Switch Pro, man. What's up? If you're coming into the stream, we're at 264 likes. We're getting close to 300 likes. Give the stream a thumbs up. Let's get it to 300 likes. Let's do it. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. We're getting close to time. 16 minutes. Oh, my thing. I have the countdown stop. Let me put the countdown back going. There we go. 13 minutes, bro. We're at 13 minutes, bro. Why does it keep doing that? Oh, there we go. Just leave it right there. Here we go. All right, let's go. All right, 12 more minutes. Let's go. Let's go. Nintendo Direct, 12 more minutes. Let me get a 12 in the chat. Where are you at? 12's in the chat. Let's get it. We're at 260. Before the Direct starts, we gotta crush 300 likes. Let's get the 300 likes before the Direct starts. Let's do it. Yo, Ant. Dum, dum, bum, 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 bum. Bum, 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 bum. All right, it's Nintendo Direct time, ladies and gentlemen. It is Nintendo Direct time. I see the 12s going up in the chat. Let's do it, man. Let's do it, man. It's showtime. 10 more minutes. 10 more minutes. Margoon. Let's go. I don't know. I might just... Well, we'll see. We'll see. We'll see what they show. We'll see what they show. Here we go. 10 more minutes, man. We're under 10 minutes. This is getting crazy. Kenneth with a $23 super chat. I'm taking a wait and see approach. I didn't watch any of the rumors or news. Sorry about that, Obi-Wan. I don't like being disappointed. I came here to hear you shout. Fingers crossed. Hey, appreciate the super chat, my guy. Much love. I hope I shout too, bro. If now let's go. Hey Kenny, appreciate it, bro. All right, it's getting close to time, bro. Let's go. We're here. Let's go. Hey, how about you? Yeah. All right, let's go, man. I can't wait. Can't wait for the games to begin. Yeah, Al, there were no leaks from this direct. So I think this is going to be dope. All right, 7 minutes. We're getting close. We're getting close, ladies and gentlemen. It's time. It's time to let the games do the talking. Nintendo. Here we go, man. What's up, Soft? What's up, bro? Yeah, there's been some fake ones, but this should be epic, man. It should be epic. Come on. So this one... this is an easy direct for Nintendo, man. I just feel like this is an easy win for Nintendo. So many possible ways they could win this, bro. So many possible ways Nintendo can win E3. Hey, we're at 286 likes. I need 14 people. Give the stream a thumbs up. We will crush 300 likes. Let's go. You hype for Super Animal Royale? No, I'm good on that melody. Mario Kart 9. So many ways. Mario Kart 9. Metroid Prime 4. Bayonetta 3. Breath of the Wild 2. Splatoon 3. Any one of those games, and they would beat Xbox for me, bro. For me. So many things they could do. But thugs say Nintendo knows how to mess up easy wins. Oh, man. Bro, we are 5 minutes away. Oh man! Oh man! Give a stream right here. Let's go. 5 minutes. Yeah, let's go. Let's go. Let's go. Should be hype. Should be hype. Should be hype. We're 5 minutes away. It's almost time. It's almost time. It's almost time. Bro, we're at 298 likes. Two people give the stream a thumbs up, and we pass 300 likes. Thanks, everyone. We did it. We did it. We did it. We crushed 300 likes. Let's go. Now, all that's next is just a direct, bro. All that's left is a direct. What does that mean? Translate. We're going to get Smash News. Metro Prime 4. That's what we want to see. One. Hey. 4 minutes. 4 minutes. 4 minutes, ladies and gentlemen. Jersey, what's up, bro? Perfect time. Let's go. Let's go. Marvel Man. Hey, Marvel Madness was lit on the NES. Thugs. These dudes don't know about that. That are watching this. Hey, what's up, Jason? Thanks for tuning in. All right. I'm cutting off my background music, everything now. It's time. It's time. At the 1 minute mark, the countdown is even coming off. Let's go, man. Nintendo, Nintendo, come on, bro. Let's go. Oh, I'm so nervous. Don't disappoint us, Nintendo. Do not leave us. Oh, and if you're watching the stream and you're not subscribed to my channel, click subscribe. Your name will show up live on stream. You know what I'm saying? And you'll be lit, bro. You'll be lit. You'll be a part of a dope, fantastic channel. If Nintendo can't win after how bad E3 been lately, there's no hope. Justin, I know, man. I'm so nervous right now, bro. So excited. Let's go. 2 minutes. 2 minutes, ladies and gentlemen. If you're just not coming into the stream, give the stream a thumbs up. We could get to 350 likes. Let's like the stream. Thumbs up, thumbs up, thumbs up. Let's go. This is it. That was in Japan, Dream Crusher. Nintendo said for the Japanese not to co-stream, which is lame. Why would they do that? Not so lame. All right. We're under 2 minutes. I'm taking down the countdown clock. At this point, we're just going to, in 2 minutes, it's going to start in 2 minutes. So let's just watch it, man. Now it's time to just enjoy the show. Let's go. Dre Day with the $2. I'm excited. Crash or Spiral for Smash. Imagine Spiral. That would be dope. That would be dope. But I don't get super. Smash is dope, but I want more. I want more than just a Smash character. Patrick has just subscribed. Thanks for subscribing, Patrick. You the GOAT. All right, here we go. 1 minute. We're in the 1 minute territory, ladies and gentlemen. Volume is all the way up. Yep, we ready. We just ready to go now. All right, I'm watching it. I'm looking, y'all, it looked like I'm looking down right here, but that's what I'm looking at, the presentation. Oh, man. It's any second now. Any second now, guys. Any second now, it's going to start. What's up, everybody coming into the stream? Share my stream on Twitter. Go to, there should be a share button at the bottom. Share it out on Twitter. Let other dudes know that you're chilling with Obi-Wan for the Nintendo Direct. It's time. It's time. It's time. This is the live feed, so we ready. We're here. Today's your birthday. Happy birthday, Jamie. Any second now. All right, it just turned 12, so it's going to start any second now. And Nintendo's always late. They always like a minute or two late. So here we go. Yeah, I'm allowed to stream it. Kelly K? What you mean, bro? What you mean, bro? Come on. Here it is. Here it is. Decent, I mean, subject to change. Our coronavirus during this challenge time. Nostalgic with the $5. Let's see what they got up their sleeves. Shout out to Nostalgic. Thanks.
Hello, everyone. I'm Shinya Takahashi, and I'll be your guide for today's Nintendo Direct.
Hello, I'm Yoshiaki Koizumi, and I'll be your guide
Koizumi.
As well.
The Nintendo Switch system is now in its fifth year, and many people around the world are playing games on it. Nintendo Switch is being enjoyed by a wide range of players spanning all ages
Make sure
and
it's
all
an
levels
HD.
Of gaming experience. Thank you all very much.
Cool.
We've been able to offer a wide variety of games on the system, not just from Nintendo, but also from our many development and publishing partners. I hope that each of you watching this Nintendo Direct will be able to find a game that suits your personal tastes.
Today, we have news on upcoming Nintendo Switch games, and we'll be focusing on a selection of games releasing this year. We hope you enjoy it.
All right, let's go.
Okay, start to begin, please take a look at this video.
Start with the banger. Let's go. What are they going to start with? Not actual gameplay footage. This Breath of the Wild 2? No! Who's carrying Ganon? What is this? Tekken?
Get ready for the next battle.
Smash! Nah. I'm not feeling this one. Nah, I'm not feeling this Smash for real. Bro, Smash? I like Tekken. Anyway, Ganon dead, said Ghoulish. Hey, K Fresh, thanks for following me. Oh, he's just throwing everybody off the cliff. Oh man, RIP Min Min. Oh, and kicked her arm. Oh! Oh, he going demon mode. New Smash Fighter. Other side, come to the other side. Look. My kids are all in here. Ah! Alright, come on, come over here. Alright, listen, after this trailer, y'all gotta get out though, okay? And take Brielle. Smile one, yo. Kazu's. Smash. Alright, so that's a new Smash Fighter. Say bye bye. Say bye bye. Oh. Oh, not Kirby! Not Kirby! Look at Kirby! Oh! Oh, Eddie watching him fall. Kirby can float. That was funny. All right, everybody out. Everybody out. Take Brielle. Get Brielle too.
Hello, I'm Masahiro Sakurai from Sora Limited and the director of the Super Smash Brothers Ultimate game.
That was
Kazuya Mishima from the fighting game series Tekken.
Bro, that was savagery. Close. Pull up the door.
Details at a later date.
Pull up the door.
So please sit tight. For today, though, bro, we prepared a short video to showcase Kazuya's moves in Super Smash Bros. Ultimate. Please take a look.
That was savage. But I'm not feeling this fight reveal. Yeah, not feeling this fighter reveal. Yeah, I know, bro. Taking it Smash. We'll still use them. I still play with them, but... Bro, you saw Kirby's face while he was just holding him? That was savage. But this didn't do anything for me. I'll try him out.
This feels like Tekken. No, it's Super Smash Bros. Ultimate. I'll talk about the fighter more in a future presentation. We still have to record it first, actually. The air date is shown below. Please stay tuned.
June 28th. That's my birthday, June 28th. That's when rumored PlayStation presentation.
A new fighter, Kazuya, will join the fight in Super Smash Bros. Ultimate.
I wasn't feeling that.
Please look forward to seeing how Kazuya, who has experienced many harsh battles across the Tekken series, will fight in this game. All right, let's continue with our first batch of
At least
they
didn't spend a lot of time on it. Let's go.
Your choices matter in these emotional supernatural tales.
What is this? I'm already not. What is this? Not for E3. Is this Volcano High? Oh. What is this? Not for E3, Nintendo. This is like a side trailer. Life is Strange. Alright, no, they didn't spend a lot of time on this. Although they are. Didn't another presentation do Life is Strange, Ubisoft? This was at the Ubisoft presentation.
Life is Strange, True Colors launches on Nintendo Switch
Come
September
on.
10th.
All right,
and
Nintendo.
Life is Strange Remastered Collection comes to Nintendo Switch later this year.
All right, come on, Nintendo.
There's something for everyone on the Nintendo Switch system. You are Star-Lord.
I said this looked like a Switch game. In this thrilling action adventure. Now we know why the game looks so trash.
Across the cosmos, overwhelm opponents with Star-Lord's daring combat style.
Now it makes sense.
Iconic and original Marvel characters.
Why the game looked trash.
Call the shots for the unpredictable Guardians as you face cosmic threats to save the galaxy. You got this, probably. Marvel's Guardians of the Galaxy blasts onto Nintendo Switch October 26th. Worms everywhere.
0-4.
In this real-time arena-based shooter,
I'm keeping
you'll switch your invertebrate opponents in 32-player cross-platform combat, play in daily challenges, battle modes, and seasonal events to
close
worm your way
You gotta
up
get out
ranks.
And close the door. You can't come in here now.
Plus,
go.
The Patchwork Bear outfit, exclusive to the Nintendo Switch version, will be available for free for 2 weeks after launch.
I said so.
A new map, Spaceport
I'll let you watch it after.
With
go.
Worms Rumble, wriggling onto Nintendo Switch June 23rd. Get a 25% discount when you pre-order the game starting today.
0-4 right now, Bucks. They 0-4 right now, bro.
The fantastical realm of Orcanon awaits. As you explore this
I changed the 4-5.
World, you'll customize a team of demigods and unleash devastating attacks.
It's an iPhone game, bro. Combat. You're doing mobile games for
After
E3?
Ascending launches on Nintendo Switch
now.
September 30th. Return to the funny, charming, and quirky world of Two Point County. In the wholesome management sim Two Point Campus, you'll build and run your very own university the way you want.
0-6, Nintendo, I said you had an easy layup.
Yours and take your educational
what are y'all doing?
Level. Enrollment for Two Point Campus starts on Nintendo Switch next year.
At least this is quick. They gotta hit us with a banger to redeem themselves.
A beloved series rolls into its 20th anniversary this year.
Oh, what's that? What's this? Come on, Nintendo. Y'all still got a lot of time, Monkey Ball. 0-7. Yahoo! Monkey Ball is lit, though. Nah, I like it. Yeah. Bro, Al, $2. Thanks for the $2. At least that put a smile on my face. Bro, what is Nintendo doing right now? Bro. Al Bundy, thanks for easing my pain a little with $2, bro.
Go bananas, win Super Monkey Ball, Banana Mania.
They really about to have Xbox win E3? They really about to make Xbox?
From parties past, and you're invited. Ready for another round of Mario Party Mayhem? Of course you are. It's a superstar collection of Mario Party boards and minigames.
It's Mario Party DLC.
Live it up on 5 classic boards from the Nintendo 64 era, including Peach's birthday cake and
that's
Space
pretty.
Land.
That's dope, but not.
Each board is packed with
zany. I'm doing games that I want.
And
Mario Party ain't
zany,
for me.
We mean it. Jump.
Arlison with the $2 says, "I'm not amused yet."
Hilarious over the top mini games. All of which support button.
You got 9 games? I went 0 for 8.
With 100 mini games from the Mario Party series catalog, you'll have a blast in this All-Star Fun Fest. Here's a little party favor.
Oh, you mean 1 out of 8 from online play. Fine, at least they got online.
Even if you're partying solo, you can randomly match with other partygoers worldwide.
Was it 0 for 9? Was it 9 games?
Save your progress I'm not playing. Game,
it's hard for me to keep track.
Then resume the festivities.
Is it 9 or 8 games they show
stickers
so far?
Are also available to
I'm gonna say 9,
0
for 9.
It's time to partay in Mario Party Superstars, launching on the Nintendo Switch system October 29th.
Mario Party
pre-orders
Superstars.
Begin today on Nintendo eShop.
What did you think? Before we show this next trailer, I'd like to say one thing.
This next game.
Currently, we're working hard on the latest game in the Metroid Prime series, Metroid Prime 4.
Yes!
Which we previously
announced. Oh, so they're going to show a Metroid game.
But today, we'd like to introduce another new entry in the Metroid franchise.
New Metroid game!
Please take a look.
Come on, Nintendo. Oh, come on. A new Metroid game. But they did let us know they're still working on Metroid Prime 4. Metroid 5? Is this Fusion? It looks dated, but it's a Metroid game, so. My thing is tough at the playing Returnal, to be like, but I can't compare Returnal to this. What is this? Now this is CGI, what is this? What is this? It's a 2D Metroid game. What is it? It's cool. Alright, this gets a win. Metroid Dread. Alright, 1 for 9. That's a win. It's not Prime 4, but it's a new 2D Metroid game. Alright, this is dope. This is a W. This is dope. I'm a Metroid fan, so this is gonna be lit. When did this come out? Please tell me it's this year. Yeah. There's a W. Alright, they already beat Xbox for me. Get this point, Gage. Let's go. Oh, frame rate. They showed a lot of gameplay. I mean, this game is launching soon. It's got to be 2021. Metroid Dread. Release date. Let's go, October 8th. Metroid Dread. October 8th.
The trailer for the first new 2D Metroid game in roughly 19 years.
Yeah.
The brand new Metroid Dread game.
Let's go.
As the name
implies,
this is a Metroid game with a new feel, showcasing a variety of threats
like
that Samus will encounter.
This really looks and plays like 2.
It's scheduled to be released on October 8th, so it won't be too long
No
until
Metroid
launch.
Prime 4, but...
On that same day, we'll also be releasing amiibo figures
those
for
amiibo
Samus
look lit.
And the Emmy, the robot seen in the video. Let's move on to more Nintendo Switch headlines.
Those amiibo look lit. It's been a minute
since
familiar
I'm franchises are back on Nintendo Switch.
All right, here comes... Oh, boy. See, they hit us with one...
Get ready to get down in the latest Just Dance game.
All right, 1 for 10. Oh, this why. I'm going to get a copyright claim, bro. Hold on. How do I? Oh, I could just mute him. Y'all ain't getting me no copyright claim, bro. We probably already got it because of that song they played. But November 4th, all right. 1 for 10.
Smash hit Cruisin' Blast is speeding onto Nintendo Switch.
1 for 11.
Blast your way through nearly 30 over-the-top tracks.
It's a mobile game, bro. Now I remember why I stopped playing my Switch.
Vehicle and hit the road.
It's like trash, bro. It's like a PlayStation 1 game, bro.
Exclusive on Nintendo Switch this fall.
1 for 11.
It's the ultimate Dragon Ball Z experience.
Kakarot, is this Kakarot?
Relive the story of Goku and other Z fighters.
1 for 12.
This
is an old game.
This action RPG.
This ain't it, sorry. It's an old game.
Saiyan, protect the Earth from an invasion by Vegeta and Nappa. Frieza, take a stand against the evil Emperor. Cell, battle the androids in a fight to the death. Majin Buu, an epic showdown with the most fearsome foe. Along with the main story, you can explore the vast world of Dragon Ball Z. Hey, why not help out the locals? Or collect ingredients for delicious meals? You could always train to acquire new skills, too. There are lots of things to keep you busy. The boss battle episodes, A New Power Awakens, Parts 1 and 2 is also included. Dragon Ball Z Kakarot, plus A New Power Awakens.
I am broken, I don't
care. Way onto Nintendo Switch September 24th.
Hey, give the stream a thumbs up. Let's get it to 350 likes.
Grab a golf club and get ready to tee off.
I'm not even counting this because this is...
The Mario Golf Super Rush game launches soon.
They already announced this.
Here's a quick glimpse into each of the modes.
Now this game does look good. Mario does look good.
Time to read the wind and terrain.
Mario Golf. Mario Golf looks good.
Hit different types of shots and aim for under par.
Nice birdie.
Speed golf. Smack your ball, then chase after it. Be the first to get your ball in the hole. Outpace your rivals with special dashes and special shots.
Metroid Dread. So far, Metroid Dread is still the show.
Battle golf.
But
duke it out over 9 flag marked holes.
Y'all be tripping while I be like all on my PlayStation 5.
3 flags to win.
Not even close to what Sony's been offering.
Go from rookie to pro with your Mii
character. Complete. Not even close, bro.
Challenges that await may surprise you. And here's some news. Free updates are planned for future release, including additional courses and playable characters. The fairway's almost open, so set your tee time and get ready to ace those shots in Mario Golf Super Rush. Swinging onto
Super
the Nintendo
Rush.
Switch
June
system June 25th. Pre-orders are available now
games.
On Nintendo eShop.
Okay,
ready for the ride of a lifetime?
Here comes another.
Welcome to the vast and Monster vibrant stories. World of
Not
Monster Hunter.
1 for 13.
As a rider in this RPG adventure, you'll explore diverse landscapes by riding your Monstie, a monster companion. Gather materials such as honey and ore, then use them to craft items for your journey.
Broken, you're horrible.
But beware of the many monsters roaming about. Some are docile, but others may suddenly ambush you. To fight, you'll team up with your Monstie and use weapons and skills to overwhelm enemy monsters in turn-based battles. Win, and you'll be rewarded with their materials.
Oh, man.
Which can be forged into new weapons and armor.
Yeah, we already saw this. We saw this a million times already, bro.
Is that an egg? You might be able to hatch a new monster. Incredibly powerful monsters can also hatch from rare eggs.
Say it ain't so.
Need more traveling buddies? Join up with friends for co-op multiplayer quests and battles. Buckle up, Ryder. It's going to be a real monster of an adventure. Monster Hunter Stories 2 Wings of Ruin soars onto Nintendo Switch July 9th. You can play the free demo on June 25th and carry over your save data to the full game.
We're halfway there. We're 20 minutes in. They said it was 40 minutes.
Here's a new game from the head of a certain
this
company.
This is Wario. WarioWare, new WarioWare game. Hey, I never played these games.
Who am I? It's a me, Wario. And it's a finally ready, a brand new game from my company. Check it out. You get to control me.
It's one for 14 for me. I ain't playing this.
To do this. Look at me go. Quack, rats. Check out these chumps. They came back.
Wario wearing for me.
Wonderful new talents. Throw that stick thing. Not so bad. Use the spinning, whatchamacallit.
Well, this is why I say I was nervous for this event, bro.
Same micro game, different abilities.
And like, it's so easy for Nintendo to win this. But I've been disappointed by Nintendo too many times, man.
Two people can play together at the same time. So play nice, or else. Eh? Not nice. All right, you. Yes, you, the one watching this. Better get ready for some micro game mayhem.
The WarioWare Get It Together game launches exclusively on the Nintendo Switch system September 10th. Pre-orders begin today on Nintendo eShop.
I'm 1 for 14 right now.
What you just saw was the trailer for WarioWare Get It Together.
Yeah, WarioWare.
In the latest installment of this series, there are new microgames that let you control Wario and his friends. There is also a two-player co-op mode, which greatly expands the gameplay.
Two-player co-op.
It's releasing in the near future, so stay tuned. Next, please take a look at this.
Come on, hit us with a banger, bro. Hang us with a banger, bro. It's that Shin Megami Tensei game.
As a high school student living in Tokyo,
1 for 15. I'm not hyped for this game. Normal. Brandon, looks like there's no reason to rush Biome 6. None, Brandon. But still do it, though. You got it, bro. You got it, bro.
After you get pulled into a different dimension.
This game, I never played Shin Megami. This game was never on my radar.
Another Tokyo exists. A post-apocalyptic world where angels and demons reside. Suddenly, you fuse with a mysterious figure, gaining the power to fight demons. What lies ahead in this alternate realm?
Shin Megami Tensei 5.
The world is now transformed into a sprawling demon-infested wasteland.
Good.
Though friendly demons do exist here, many are hostile and will attempt to destroy you. Harness your newfound powers to fight demons using a command-based system. Finding their weak point is key. By targeting it, the number of consecutive actions you can perform in a combo will increase. Though demons are formidable opponents.
Yeah, I think this will be a good
you
game, especially if you're a fan of the series.
Negotiations, which
thanks
begin
for following.
Open a
if you're not subscribed to my channel, click subscribe right now. Click subscribe. Also, give the stream a thumbs up. We're at 350
if the negotiation
likes.
Is successful,
let's get to 400 likes.
Will become a powerful ally.
Be Cerebus.
In some cases, by rejecting a demon.
I like RPGs.
They may feel
just,
motivated.
I don't know.
And join you as an ally.
I'm still gonna play Final Fantasy VII Integrate. I still gotta play
that.
Bro.
Fight alongside
my backlog.
You and grow stronger. By fusing demon allies, another demon can be created. The newly fused demon's innate abilities will vary, granting you a powerful ally customized to your needs and playstyle. Challenge the many demons roaming this post-apocalyptic world by harnessing the power of your own.
Kaleem said, throw the hype hat in the trash. That's why I ain't put the iPad on, bro. Nintendo ain't getting me again.
Nintendo Switch, November 12th.
November 12th.
Pre-orders for the physical version.
There's going to be too many other games in November, bro.
That was the latest trailer for Shin Megami Tensei 5 from
Was that
Atlas.
16 or 15? One for 16?
This is the newest game in the series. Please look forward to future updates. Let's see a few more Nintendo Switch headlines.
Celebrate 10 years of Danganronpa in despair.
Al Bunny, we're more than halfway through. It looks like Splatoon 3 is the flagship game. We'll see, Al.
Mic check 1-2. This is a test of the school.
It's 1 for 17.
Three games in the deadly Danganronpa series are coming to Nintendo Switch. Monokuma, the self-proclaimed school headmaster, has trapped you and other students
thanks.
In a game
thanks,
of
bro,
literal
for the $5
life
super
and
chat.
Death. Unfortunately, the only way out of the school and this lethal game is to betray the other students. And so it begins.
A body has been discovered!
When a student meets their demise, a class trial will take place to reveal the culprit.
You're the culprit, aren't you, Mew?
Johnny, I had no idea.
They probably moved the body there.
Use the evidence you've gathered to refute contradictions and find the guilty party.
Sneak attack.
Thanks for subscribing.
Are you
or
okay?
Follow me on Twitch, too.
Plus, the board game from Danganronpa V3 Killing Harmony
oh,
has been expanded
up,
into a standalone game.
One for 18.
Danganronpa S Ultimate Summer Camp.
Only Metro.
An all-star cast of characters from the Danganronpa series will come together to battle at a tropical resort. Who's the strongest of them all in this ultimate beach brawl? The four-game collection Danganronpa Decadence launches as a physical exclusive on Nintendo Switch later this year. All four games will also be individually available on
Nintendo
eShop.
Nope, you're not.
We hope you're not afraid of ghosts.
What is this? What is this? Fatal Frame. 0-19 for me. I'm not trying to get no further further. LeBron, thanks for subscribing
game,
to my YouTube
you uncover
channel,
the
bro.
Mysteries surrounding the ethereal but deadly Mount Hikami. Believed to be at the center of many disappearances.
Facts, bro.
Ghosts
I thought this game.
This mountain.
This game was on the
Your
Wii U.
Only defense
is this
is
a Wii U game?
Repel and cast them out.
This is a Wii U game.
Face
they pour into the Switch.
As you explore a variety of unsettling locations. This spine-chilling story features various protagonists, letting you experience the game from different perspectives. New costumes and photo modes are included in this version. Can you investigate Mount Hikami? And stay alive. Fatal Frame, Maiden of Black Water, creeps onto Nintendo Switch this year.
Is that a Wii U game?
These games and DLC are coming soon. Some even today. Your war is not over. Raise hell in the first campaign expansion for Doom Eternal, The Ancient Gods Part 1. Deeper and more challenging combat awaits as you eliminate Hell's newest threats.
If you're gonna buy this game, get it on your Xbox or PlayStation. Bro.
The fate of the cosmos is in your hands. Get slaying when this campaign expansion launches on Nintendo Switch
campaign
later today.
Expansion. Today, launches today. That's dope. Usman,
get
thanks for subscribing.
Two iconic skateboarding games fully remastered in HD.
Old.
Skate to era-defining jams as the legendary Tony Hawk and a roster of new
Nothing,
and returning
bro.
Pros. Take your sessions on the go with
show
all
off
the
those
original
Xbox
game modes
games. You're right.
And compete locally or
now?
Online to show off your tricks against other
You can
skaters.
Get a better version of this game
Drop
on PlayStation
Tony Hawk's
or
Pro
Xbox.
Skater
bro.
1 and 2 launching on Nintendo Switch June 25th. Pre-orders are available now on Nintendo eShop.
Better like a PlayStation 2 game on a Switch, bro.
I'm keeping it a buck, bro. Years, I ain't sugarcoating nothing, bro. Has risen from the dead. Oh my goodness, and only one group of heroes can
stop her. What is this, bro?
The Strange Brigade. In this thrilling adventure, you'll blast through an army of mummified monstrosities while solving puzzles in booby-trapped dungeons. Go it alone or team up with other daring adventurers.
Oh my goodness,
local wireless co-op,
bro, this looks
and
just
play.
Like PlayStation 2, PlayStation
Expect
3.
The
game.
Unexpected. When Strange Brigade launches on Nintendo Switch later today.
Nintendo's so far behind, man. Man, forget the Switch Pro. They just need a home console,
it's
bro.
It's a new adventure of
cosmic All right, this is lit. Two, finally, another one. A two for 22, but...
Mario and his friends will team up with the Rabbids once again to
this was already shown at
galaxy.
Ubisoft presentation.
Our heroes must stop a mysterious new evil from plunging the universe into chaos. Rabbid Rosalina joins them.
This
Wait,
is
she bored already?
CJ, this is
Explore
gameplay.
Explore planets filled with quirky residents and even quirkier secrets.
Yeah, I'm gonna be good on
and
my PS5
this fresh take
this gen,
on the tactical
man.
Genre. Our heroes can
I'm gonna be good on my
PS5
this gen, man.
Creating new strategic and chaotic possibilities. So aim for victory with a little help from your friends. Wait, who's that? Well, one thing's certain. This is gonna be one heck of a galactic adventure. Mario plus Rabbids, Sparks of Hope, launches into space or onto Nintendo Switch next year.
Oh, that's 2022. Oh, wow. That ain't even coming out this year. I thought it was coming out this year. What's this? What's this? This is what you do for E3, bro? This what you do for E3, bro? I'm tweeting out. How is Nintendo? Bruh! Is this Advance War?
Thrilling stories. Memorable characters.
Is this Advance War?
Game player in store as you lead the commanding officers to victory. Play the first two Advance Wars campaigns and Advance Wars.
Now, Advance Wars are dope games,
but marching on to Nintendo Switch this holiday. Pre-orders begin today on Nintendo eShop.
How is everything? All right. This next segment
will be our last
announcement of the day. Please take a look.
All right, it's going to be a big game, either Splatoon or Zelda. It's going to be a big one. No! This is not their last announcement! No Splatoon! No Zelda! Breath of the Wild 2! Oh, they failed. Bro, they failed so bad. You had one job, Nintendo. Nah, there has to be one more surprise after this. There has to be one more surprise. I'm not even watching Treehouse. Forget that. You think I'm gonna stay up for the next 3 hours to watch Treehouse after this? Man, I'm done. I'm done, bro. Did he just say this is their last? Nah. Now, there has to be Breath of the Wild. Oh, here we go, Aonuma. Okay, Breath of the Wild 2.
Hello there. Okay. I'm Eiji Aonuma,
but even now,
of the Legend of Zelda series.
Okay, they're going to show
what
Breath of the Wild 2.
What you've just seen is a trailer for the first wave of DLC for the Hyrule Warriors Age of Calamity.
They're
going to
show Breath of the Wild 2. Whenever Aonuma comes on, they got to.
It will follow Link and his allies through more battles that took place 100 years
down,
prior
kiss the ring,
to the
says
events
Colleen.
Of the Legend of Zelda Breath of the Wild.
And Al Bundy says there's only 2 minutes,
I have
8 minutes
more
left. Thanks.
To share with you all
thanks,
today.
thanks for the $2. They're going to do Breath of the Wild 2.
The Legend of Zelda Skyward Sword HD game, which launches next month. You'll immerse yourself
I'm
in the world
this.
Of Link by using two Joy-Con controllers.
I already played this.
For
already beat this.
Motion controls.
Claims it
by
out and kiss
the handheld mode, wielding the sword via flicking the stick and button only.
So they're gonna end it with Breath of the Wild 2.
This game depicts the oldest
but
era
that's
in
that
the
was that's
Zelda
not
series,
enough for me, bro.
The story of how it all began.
Well, we'll see. We'll see. They may have us. The origin of the Master Triforce Sword. Heroes type game surprise.
Why did a woman named Zelda become the legend for future generations? These will all be unraveled in this game.
I like the story in this game, but I'm not spending
$60. We hope you're looking forward to The Legend of Zelda Skyward Sword HD.
2 for $23. No, 24, because they showed 24 next and up. 25. 25, 2 for $25.
Here's a little something you might like. This is a Game & Watch system that lets you play three games in the Legend of Zelda series.
That's a collector's
This year, the original Legend of Zelda game reaches its 35th anniversary. While we don't have any campaigns or other Nintendo Switch games planned, we've been working on this Game & Watch system as a special item to help mark the occasion and reflect fondly on the earliest days of The Legend of Zelda.
Wait, they're not even going to show Breath of the Wild 2?
It will come with the first game I'm in the series, The Legend of Zelda.
Isn't this already on our
Zelda
Switch?
Zelda 2, The Adventure
These are already
of Link,
on our Switch, bro!
And the Game Boy version of The Legend of Zelda Link's Awakening game, as well as a special version of the Game & Watch title Vermin, starring Link as the playable character.
Is he hitting clouds?
So that's four games on one system, from longer Legend of Zelda games.
It's like he's just whacking clouds.
Game Vermin. In addition, regarding the watch functionality for the Game & Watch system, we've added a playable clock based on The Legend of Zelda, and an interactive timer themed after Zelda 2, The Adventure of Link.
I can't believe this direct
has been
so trash,
bro. You can
play
with both of them
by
taking control of Link.
An easy layup!
We hope you'll enjoy playing this Game & Watch system whenever and wherever you'd like.
Bro! Now y'all wondering why am I only on my
PS5.
Right,
here's the last thing we have to show you.
Breath of the Wild 2.
This is the sequel to The Legend of Zelda, Breath of the Wild.
All right, at least they
2 years
this.
Have passed since we first announced this
still,
game,
still
and
been
we've been
so
unable to share anything
for,
with you in that time.
3 for $25.
However, development has been steadily progressing. For today, we've prepared some new footage to show a bit
right.
more of the game.
Right, at least they
Please
shown
take
some
a look.
Game. 3 for $25. It's still not enough for me, but I gotta enjoy. I gotta at least enjoy this, bro. Oh, we're going in the sky? Oh, that looks just like Breath of the Wild 1. They use the same engine. Oh, he could go through. All the smoke. Da, na, 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 na. That's it. All right, that was a good tease. Did they just win with that one trailer over Microsoft? Yeah, they're doing. How they beat Xbox?
But so, still what did you think? This time around, the setting for the adventure has been expanded to include the skies above Hyrule.
All right,
we'd like to ask
Is
you to
the trailer.
We're aiming for a 2022 release, so I hope you'll look forward to it.
2022. Coming 2022. This was trash. It was still trash.
How was
though.
That?
They beat Xbox, but it was
for
trash.
This Nintendo Direct. We are diligently continuing development on a number of other games we didn't show today. I hope you'll continue looking forward
Breath
to
of
what's
Wild.
In store on Nintendo Switch.
Two.
Thank you for watching.
All right, I am not staying on. For no, I hop in the voice chat real quick, but I'm about to head out. I'm just so disappointed, bro. But that was trash. That was trash, bro. That was trash. Hey, Breath of the Wild 2 made him beat Xbox, though.
I'm Doug Bowser from Nintendo of America. and I'm here with Nate Bildorf, who leads our Treehouse team.
I ain't staying for this Treehouse. You know, forget that.
At Nintendo, we're all about creating experiences.
Yeah, it was trash.
Surprises and smiles.
That was trash.
I have to say, I found myself smiling through that entire presentation.
Yeah, that was trash.
About how many unique games we'll be able to
show.
What is Nintendo doing, bro?
I don't what are they doing? Know,
that
bro.
Last clip was incredible.
What are they
bro,
doing, bro,
they have the Breath of the Wild 2 made them beat Xbox for me, but they still try.
Nah, bro, take my Switch into GameStop after this, and I'm about to say, here, take this trash off my hands.
Yeah, that was trash. Yeah,
give me some PlayStation credit for my Switch.
Yeah, bro, you might as well. That was trash.
Bro, no Wind Waker, no Twilight Princess. Ain't we in the anniversary?
And they literally said we have no Zelda games coming.
No other games. So that's it. This is it.
Yeah.
Nothing else for the 35th. Yo, what's up, Rambo? Man.
Wow. Mario Party. I love Mario Party.
No, that,
hey, Obi,
that,
did
that
I not tell you that they
me,
treat?
Bro.
Did I not tell you that they treat Zelda like the redheaded stepchild?
You said it, Bucks. You called it, Jordan. What's up, bro?
Oh,
God, bro. Oh, we not on that Mario Party.
Hey, Bucks.
Nah, I'm good.
I'm going to Xbox with that one.
Why? Bro, let me tweet this out.
I was Xbox Direct, Obi. What did Xbox?
It was trash too, but it was. I think they tied for being trash. Xbox and Nintendo tied for being trash.
Xbox got it, man. Nintendo. Sorry, bro. Like it was so much. It was
bro, I'm so hurt right now. What were they doing, man?
Yoshio Sakamoto, who is the producer of Metroid Dread, and he.
That was disappointing. Hey, man.
Told you to lower your expectations.
Yeah. Man, Boostash, I'm so disappointed. Hey, but hey, I'm calling it, man. I'm gonna head out. I'm not watching this. This 3-hour Treehouse. Forget that. Hey, but I'll be on later today, man. I don't know when. I don't even know if I'm going to stream the Bandai Namco presentation. The E3 just been trash this year, man. Hey, but thanks y'all for coming by, man. It was a disappointment.
Yeah, bow down and kiss the ring, guys.
You said it, Kaleem. You said it. You called it, man. All right, y'all. I'm heading out.
10, though. 3 out of 10.
That was trash, broken. That was straight trash.
Xbox 2 out of 10.
All right, I'm heading out. That was horrible. Hey, I'll see y'all later, man. I'm out. PS4.